insurance, see shelter agent Stephen Elmore or give him a call at 501-537-0959.
If there's anything green in your yard right now, it's probably a weed, and you need to do something about it. Weed Control and Fertilization Service from Sanders Ground Essentials is easier and less expensive than doing nothing or trying to do it yourself. I did that one time and almost killed my yard. Sanders Ground Essentials saves you time and money and makes your yard the envy of the neighborhood. Don't wait. Do it now. Call Sanders Ground Essentials and get started with Sanders Ground Essentials Weed Control Program. Servicing all of Central Arkansas, including West Little Rock and Conway. On the web at sandersground.com. Let's get growing.
Join the Zone broadcasting live Tuesday from the VIP lot at Simmons Bank Arena for the Regional Recycling's Electronic Recycling Event. Drop off your old electronics for free between 7 a.m. and 2 p.m. Tuesday and Wednesday. For more information, go to recyclingunplugged.com.
When it comes to bikes, here's what you want. Reliable, fast, and tough as nails. That's what you get at OCC. And after a crash, that's what you get at Rainwater, Holt, and Sexton.
Paul Sr. knows this. We're the Arkansas law firm motorcyclists have counted on for years.
We work fast to get you the best results, and we're tough where it counts, fighting for you.
Reliable, fast, tough as nails. These are the guys I'd call anywhere in the state. Dial 888-8888.
Non-lawyer spokesperson. Responsible attorneys Michael Rainwater and Bob Sexton.
Clint Sterner here. Guys, if you've noticed a lack of energy, motivation, and drive, it could be low T. Be sure to schedule your health assessment at Low T Center. For established patients, they offer the convenience of physician-monitored self-inject at-home testosterone treatments with an average payment of $150 a month cash pay, including labs and medication. If you need the convenience of at-home treatment, Low T Center makes it easy, shipping treatments directly to your house. Go to lowtcenter.com now to book your appointment online. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Live from the Signal Media Studios, this is Out of Bounds with Joe Franklin and Wes Moore on 103.7 The Buzz.
My left stroke just went viral.
We knew it was going to happen. When he came back, it was going to just solidify our defense. Another left-handed hitter, maybe a guy that could hit leadoff. If not, we're going to hit him two-hole, three-hole. But I think he likes leading off. You know, he'll take a walk, but he'll also hit you a home run every now and then. And he's having a, you know, you got to think about this. He's hitting 360 or something. And he's doing it all against the league. He didn't get any of them cookie games, you know, when the wind's blowing out 30 miles an hour and the wind's out of the north and we're playing somebody that has run out of pitching and we're scoring 10, 12, 15 runs. I mean, he pretty much has to do it, been doing it against the SEC. So, and he's, you know, I looked at his numbers yesterday. I think he, what do you have, like 40 at-bats now or 35, 40 going into today, and if that. And so when his at-bats pick up, he's going to get even more comfortable. And, but yeah, I think he's just brought a spark to our lineup. He's brought a spark to our middle infield. And, you know, sometimes that's what you need. You need one more guy.
Dave Van Horn on Peyton Stovall. Great weekend for the Louisiana kid out of Houghton, Louisiana against LSU. And Arkansas sweeps the Tigers, and the Tigers go tumbling down the top 25 rankings. Arkansas, of course, remains a unanimous number one. Saw the D1 rankings came out earlier this morning. The other rankings are coming out. And Arkansas, number one. Number two team, Oregon State, lost both of their games last week to USC, so they fall in the rankings. And Arkansas kind of just gets a firmer grasp, if you can, of that number one spot. Now I think they got a little cushion if something was to happen and they lost a series down the road. They may still be number one because of the respect and all the great games they've already won against top 25 teams like LSU, Oregon State, Auburn at the time. So anyway, great weekend for Arkansas. I was so happy for Peyton Stovall. This is a kid who turned down LSU. Now, LSU, did not think that Stovall was going to go to college. They thought he was so good he was going to get drafted, and so they didn't put a lot of time and effort into recruiting Stovall until the very end when they kind of finally figured out, you know what, there's a chance he's going to college. And then
It
was too late, and they were like, we're going to Arkansas. No, you had your chance, you blew it. So very happy for Stovall and to do that against the LSU Tigers. Because last year, you know, his series wasn't bad. It just wasn't great down there in Baton Rouge. But this year, that was a great series for Peyton Stovall to hit over 500. He'll get some, I don't know if the SEC Players of the Week has come out, not that I really care, but there's a chance batting over 500 against LSU, he could be the Player of the Week.
Friday's game was key also because Arkansas got off to the good start, got the first win under their belt. Second game goes to extra innings, goes to the 10th inning. They come away with a close win there. So they had already won the series, but just the way that it all went down and then to come back and top it off Saturday and get the sweep, that's all you can ask for, especially against a really talented team when you're wanting to hold on to that number one spot and prove that you're number one for a reason. Mm-hmm.
It's awesome to look at the standings right now, and Arkansas is 8-1 in the SEC West, and LSU falls to 2-7. You know, that was a team that was picked to finish second behind Arkansas, and I think now the main worry is going to be Texas A&M to catch Arkansas. They're two games back, and they'll finish the season with Texas A&M down in College Station. But right now, man, Arkansas is rolling. Kentucky is 8-1. And surprising a lot of people. They weren't picked to finish picked very high in the SEC. And they just keep winning. They keep getting a couple, just like Arkansas, a couple sweeps and another series win. And Kentucky's 8-1 in the East. And that'll be a good matchup to watch. Now, Kentucky, I can't remember the connection, but they've got an assistant on their staff that has Arkansas ties. And he's recruited some Arkansas kids over the years. And so there are a couple of Arkansas connections there on that Kentucky staff, and they've been able to surprise a lot of people this year. This week, Arkansas has Arkansas State tomorrow night. That'll be fun, another little in-state game. And then it's Ole Miss Thursday, Friday, Saturday at Baumwalker. So back-to-back series against LSU and Ole Miss. And you took a poll for Razorback baseball fans. That's the two teams right there. That's the two rivals. LSU and Ole Miss, and you get them back-to-back weekends at home and a chance to put some distance between them and Ole Miss with a series win or, who knows, maybe a sweep. But, Joe, when they won that game in extra innings Friday night, man, that was so cool too. Exciting finish, great way to do it, to walk it off. I knew. I was like, I heard Akery say it. I did the same thing. I just knew they were going to win Saturday, and I bet on Arkansas and gave up the run and a half. I felt like the pitching matchup was so much favored Arkansas, even though Brady Tigert, you know, still hasn't worked out his issues with his mechanics, gave up some long balls. But the pitching for LSU was going to be on the slim side, and Arkansas took advantage and scored a lot of runs against the Tigers. And I felt like they learned, or maybe that bad taste in their mouth after not getting the sweep against Auburn, I just felt like the focus would be there. And they would be a little bit more intent. Not that they weren't trying to beat Auburn, but, you know, they felt like they let that get away, slip away, especially with a lead against Auburn. I just felt really good about Saturday's game. And so I was not surprised at all that they got the sweep.
When you go into a series and you get the first two games, of course, everything lines up. But we know that it doesn't always work like that because the opponent, they already realize that they've lost the series, but they want to try to salvage something.
Yep.
And get another win under their belt. So it becomes probably a harder game than people really imagine. But for Arkansas to come away with a sweep, it just says how they are this year and you know, how they played up to potential so far.
The hitting story, Stovall was one of them, but the pitching story, Will McIntyre, my gosh, this dude is so steady, Eddie. Comes in out of the bullpen. And just it's a calming presence on the mound, and the team just seems to respond to him when he's in the game. And, man, two big performances Thursday and Saturday from Will McIntyre.
Well, that's one reason we put him in there, because he's older, he's been there, and really doesn't get rattled. And, you know, he just came in there and kind of did what he does. And, you know, just excited for him. He's He's really having a good year for us, and he's been Mr. Reliable. And, you know, I didn't write his name on the board. I didn't write it on the lineup card. And when I went, and I always post a lineup card down by the locker room, when I went and got it right before we got stretch, his name just appeared on there because I guess he wrote it in there. So I said something to Coach Hobb, and he said, yeah, he wrote it in there. And so, you know, we didn't want him doing much. And I guess he threw 24 pitches, and that was all he needed to throw right there. So glad it worked out.
How freaking cool is that? Coach didn't even write his name down for pitchers available, and this dude goes up, sees that list, and is like, Will McIntyre, I'm available. I want in the game. That shows you he's been around, he's confident enough, and he knows his body, and he knows when that he's ready to go. And pencils his name in on the lineup card.
Well, we know players want to play, and sometimes you do have to make your presence felt in certain situations. We heard that with L. Ellis during basketball season, that Coach Muss asked for guys to take the floor. He didn't ask for a starting five or anything, and L. Ellis ran onto the floor. And so that was how he actually was able to get back into the games and get some playing time, just simply because he showed up in that moment. So that's something that players realize, like when you're asked certain things and you just volunteer for it, that's going to be recognized, and it can lead to you getting playing time or getting in certain games that maybe you weren't thought about.
Coaches like to see that. Who wants it? You know, who's going to step up in that moment? And in this moment, it was writing his name on the card for L. It was stepping up in practice. But that sends a message not only to the coaching staff, but also to your teammates also, that this is your moment, and you're ready to take that moment and grasp it and run with it. And so you like to see those kind of competitors on your team.
Now the only thing that could happen for a coach to see everybody step up in the moment, if you see multiple guys, you see like four guys run up, and then you know that you can't put all four of them on the floor. So then now you have to make a choice, but it's a good choice at that point because now you realize that these guys are showing some effort.
Competition, that's great for a team. We'll talk some more Razorback baseball throughout the day, and we'll take some phone calls, 661-1037, 661-1037. I've got a lot of things we're going to hit on today. It's because it was a huge weekend. Of course, the NCAA Tournament Final Four is here. That is our question of the day.
It is. Let's see. Early results. Which team do you want to see win men's championship, NCAA men's championship? Right now, overwhelmingly, it's NC State, 59.7%. UConn, surprisingly, second at 33.9%. And then Purdue, Bama, they're both at 3.2%. So nobody wants to see Mm-mm. Purdue or Bama win. Mm-mm. So it looks like the matchup they're wanting to see is UConn, NC State, with NC State getting it done.
Yeah, I can – sure. Cinderella, North Carolina State, I get that. UConn, I get that too. Back-to-back, people like winners, people like dominance, and that's what we're seeing out of UConn. The dominance they displayed last year on their run to a national championship, and they're doing it again this year, just blowing teams out. A 30-0 run this weekend in the second half. To start the second half, 30-0 run? Are you kidding me? I voted for UConn. Now that Tennessee is out, and my bracket is officially done, I'd like to see UConn win it because I like excellence and what they have done the last year and a half, year and 7/8, I guess, has been pretty remarkable. And so I'm all aboard, ready for UConn.
Rebound, Caravan, out, Tiara, a triple. Nathan is one side, Newton got it. Clinging inside, Hawkins is there.
Change to have Caravan on demand.
Castle, clinging the bench and in for the Illini. Caravan inside. Rebound inside, Spencer. It's Diarra. Newton, clinging, thrashing his way inside.
And you've got the dish to Hawkins wide open there.
Caravan with a three. Sampson Johnson. Here they go. Johnson in there. Twirls and scores. Rebound picked up by Newton. 16 straight misses. And Goody throws it away. Spencer Diarra, the number one overall seed, Connecticut, will try to become the first program to repeat as a national champion in 17 years. UConn is going back to the Final Four.
Of all the things that I've heard in the last hour, maybe the most surprising from my end is you cried a little bit today. Why is that?
I'm a crier. You know, I laugh. I yell. I cry. You know, was at the Jimmy V. That's a full day. And, you know, obviously you pour a lot of yourself into this job, a lot of yourself emotionally, into your players, into your organization. You know, physically, it's, you know, these seasons are long, and when you're really going for it the way we are, you know, you are filled with emotion. You leave the hotel, and there's hundreds of UConn fans high-fiving you on the way to getting on the bus to come over here to go for your second Final Four in a row. And, you know, when you got things going through your mind, too, that you're trying to block out, like, you know, that my son, this may be my last year coaching my son. You know, Cam Spencer, I got to get this guy to a Final Four. Steph Castle, this team deserves Phoenix. You know, you're just, you know, you're emotional.
And then when you're emotionally spent, sometimes it flows out. You know, you can't help yourself. But to invest so much into a team, into a season, man, I get it. And UConn and Hurley, man, there are times they make it look easy. They're so good defensively, and then they're better offensively. And I know it goes hand in hand, but that's when you know you got a dominant team, when both sides, offense and defense, are great.
Well, think about the game with Illinois when they go on the 30-0 run. It's tied at the time. So even if they go on, it's almost unimaginable that they go on a 30-0 run, but it's tied. So if they go on a 10-0 run, 15-0 run, those are the types of runs that you've seen from UConn where they're putting the games away at some point mid-game, and then by the time it gets to the end, it's not even a game anymore. The opponent doesn't even have a chance. But 30-0 run, it's just incredible.
What was it? Tied at 28 or something?
23.
23? And they go on the 30-0 run. And just game over. Think about being so close if you're Illinois. And you had played – poorly offensively, you know, mainly because of UConn's defense. But you're like, we're there. You know, here's the coach. Guys, we're playing terrible offensively. We can't make a shot. Nothing's falling for us, and we're tied. We're right there. We got a chance in this game. And a couple minutes later, after a 30-0 run, it's like, pack your bags. Let's go. I mean, what do you say? You just gave up a 30-0 run.
You try to chip away, but at that point, yeah. UConn's just too dominant.
Coming up on the show today, I'm excited. We got Barry Odom, former Razorback defensive coordinator, joining us at the top of the 2 o'clock hour after the Razor Hog update. Coach, of course, now at UNLV, made news not too long ago by riding a bull. Want to talk to him about that
bucket
experience?
List.
Man, he took a little hit. I mean, that bull came back and see how he felt after getting knocked off of that bull. I think he stayed on about 2 seconds. One little buck.
That's about average.
Yeah, no doubt. No doubt. But to do that, I mean, hey, tip of the cap to him to even say, okay, I'll do this. I mean, how many people would do that? I mean, I'll try a lot of things. I'm not riding a bull. No, I grew up, you know, in Texas and rodeos and stuff. No, that's not. I don't want any part of that. Kudos to Barry Odom. So anyway, he's got a lot of Arkansas kids on that team, so I thought it'd be cool to catch up with him and just see how things are going out there. Joe Klein will join us in the third hour. We'll talk about the NCAA tournament with him. He's got to be excited. I mean, North Carolina State, they play through the post. UConn, they utilize their big guys. Purdue, obviously, with the big guy. And even Alabama with this, you know, they
– Grant Nelson, he floats around the perimeter, but he can play inside.
It's not really old school throw it into the post basketball, but their centers are a big part of what they do there. So Joe's will be fun to talk to in that third hour and see. And that matchup with North Carolina State-Purdue, Akery and I were talking about it a little bit before the show, and it's just so intriguing because, you know, the Burns has the weight, not so much the height, And he's going to be giving up a lot of inches. I saw he's listed at 6'9". NFL scouts were talking about him, and they said he's probably truly 6'7". That's 8 inches he's given up. Size-wise, he can push around and use that mass to hopefully keep Zach Edey from getting set in the low block where he wants to. But the thing for me is the pick and roll. They do so much pick and roll at Purdue, and it's not even so much of the picking or the rolling. They just like to get Edey free because whoever's guarding him has to go with the roller on offense, you know, to stop the guard. And then he tries to run back and get in position, and he's able to get in position. But by then, Edey's already set up 2-3 feet from the goal. So it's too late. You've got to have another big guy that can come over and try to help off and push him out of that spot. Their pick and roll was so effective, and it had nothing to do with him. You know, very rarely did they hit him on the roll. It was more or less just dribble out, let him get set underneath the basket, and then throw it to him because he's got the perfect post position. That's what I worry about with North Carolina State. But they got a week to figure that out. How are they going to defend that?
Every team that's faced Purdue has given up size this year. It wouldn't matter if you had a 7-footer on the team. You're still giving up size to Zach Edey. But there have been a few that have been able to figure it out as far as when to double him, when to double whoever the picker is, the screener maybe. Mm-hmm. But you want to pick your spots. You don't want to run the same defense at them because then they are going to figure it out wherever – Zach Edey is able to get in the post and get it positioning. But, I mean, he's been a matchup problem the entire time he's been at Purdue, and this is the farthest that they've gone so far. So they've gotten it to work now, but you can always go back and look at film to see how someone has defended them and what has worked to try to emulate that and see if you can put it into your own game plan and make it work.
North Carolina, what a run. What a just a Cinderella story. Continue to be the underdog. Continue to win outright. It is I've made some nice money off of them just taking the points and a couple times money line North Carolina State. I'm a little worried with this game just because of the way Purdue's playing and just to me, I think the two best teams are, I'm going out on a limb, UConn and Purdue. And they've shown it all year. They've shown it in this tournament. And I feel like they're on a collision course for the championship game.
Yeah, those two teams, before if we were mid-season and before it even got to where it was kind of taking shape, those were the two teams that many people thought would have been playing for the championship in the end. But we know that it's much more than that. You still have to go through the regular season. You have to get through conference tournaments, which at that time they have – They know they're in the NCAA tournament, but then once you get into the tournament, it's still six games to win a championship, so it's not as easy as some of these teams, like how UConn has made it look easy so far. You still have to win six games. Think about with NC State. NC State won five games in a row to get in, and now they've won four in a row. They're on a nine-game win streak, and they still need to win two more games to win it all.
Win the championship. They had. I was reading a story. They lost their last five games of the regular season. Their coach was on the hot seat. They weren't going to the NCAA tournament, and they go to the ACC tournament and win five in a row to get to the tournament. And then it doesn't stop there. It's just that's an incredible story of how they've been able to put it together, and it just shows you it's never too late to put it together, to get on that hot streak, to get on that run. And who knows what happens with your season. And, by the way, the last team to win, the only other team to win five games in 5 days at their tournament was UConn. And UConn went on to win the national championship. That's what North Carolina State's trying to do right now.
That's why it is so rare, simply because it's hard to just turn that switch on when you get to a certain point. Coaches preach it when you get the tournament time, when you get the conference tournament, and if you have to win that conference tournament to get in, they're going to preach it. They're going to say this is what we need to do, and we can go. We can. We're potentially able. We're capable of going on a run like this, but it's a lot easier said than done, and NC State has done it.
Do you remember what the overall seeding was, the top four or five seeds for the tournament when it came out? Like, UConn was the number one seed. Who was 2, 3, 4?
don't remember how the order was.
I was thinking about this on the ride home last night. Surely Purdue wasn't the fourth seed, right? Or the fourth as far as the rankings. Then Tennessee was five.
Check out the bracket there. And just let's go through the one seeds and we can.
North Carolina and Houston were the other number ones
with
Purdue.
Yeah, so Purdue may have been third or fourth.
Because they said, I remember reading, Tennessee was number five overall. They were the highest ranked two seed. And I thought, well, that's unfair that they were stuck with Purdue and not North Carolina.
Yeah,
but North Carolina one of the, you know, as far as the ranking, 1, 2, 3, 4, when they seeded the overall top 64 of the tournament, did they do that as Purdue is 4 and Tennessee 5? Or was it a regional thing where they wanted to put Purdue in the Midwest region and Tennessee just got stuck with them?
It was always thought as the top 2 seed that you wouldn't face off against the top 1 seed or even the second 1 seed. You get the 3 or the 4. But Purdue, for that fourth overall seed, it had to be either Purdue or UNC.
Yeah.
You could swap them out to say 1 is 3, 1 is 4. But it had to be one of the two, because doubt if it was Houston that was number 4.
We'll talk more about the NCAA tournament. We're going to talk some about the women's games tonight. We've got the Barry Odom interview, Joe Klein. But next, we're going to talk some spring football. Arkansas had a big scrimmage on Saturday. Curtis Wilkerson will join us. He was there. I want to get his thoughts, his report on what he saw, what we need to kind of keep an eye on, what's going well for this team, what's not, what are they still kind of worried about. So I thought it would be good to get somebody that was there at the scrimmage. We also, remember, we gave away 3 pairs of tickets to our listeners to go to the LSU-Arkansas game on Saturday, and a couple of them said they were going to the scrimmage. And I asked them to call us, and you got to call us on Monday. So I'm expecting some phone calls from some folks that went up to the scrimmage to give us that report.
They may not have gotten up at 8 o'clock.
I hope they did. I want to hear from them. All right, we're going to hear from Curtis Wilkerson next. We'll get a practice report, or in this case, a scrimmage report on the Razorbacks. And then Barry Odom, top of the second hour, 2 o'clock, 2:10. We'll hear from Coach Odom. Stick around. We're just getting started. This is Out of Bounds.
Fence Brokers presents Razorback Graffiti every Monday morning. Call Morning Mayhem and let them know how you feel about how they did. One sentence and one sentence only.
This is SportsCenter.
The Final Four of the men's college basketball is set and will be played on Saturday. Purdue will take on NC State in Game 1 at 5:09. NC State is back in the Final Four for the first time since winning the national championship in 1983, while Purdue is making it for the first time since 1980. UConn and Alabama will face off in Game 2 at 7:49. It's the Tide's first ever Final Four appearance. The Huskies are currently favored by over 10 points. Both games will be on CBS. And in the Elite Eight of the women's tournament, Iowa will take on LSU in the national championship rematch tonight at 6 on ESPN, and then following that game, UConn and USC will face off at 8. NC State and South Carolina already punched their tickets to the Final Four. They'll face each other on Friday. I'm Christian Weaver with the Buzz Radio Network.
Sanders Ground Essentials presents Belinda Mayo when she joins Morning Mayhem each Thursday morning. Sanders Ground Essentials, where great lawns start today. On the web at sandersground.com. It's Belinda Mayo each Thursday with Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz.
What do you do when the power goes out? Well, now you can do anything you want when you purchase a Generac home standby generator from Generator Supercenter of Little Rock. Come visit the experts at Central Arkansas's only generator showroom, located on Chenal Parkway in West Little Rock. We offer a turnkey solution, financing, and 24/7 service. Visit our website for more info at generatorsupercenterofLittleRock.com. The standby power people.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential, but finding those people can be a major hassle, unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze, and right now you can try it for free at ziprecruiter.com/free. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. and the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
It's Justin Akre for Serta Pro Painters, and if you're like me, this time of the year, I'm spending a lot of time at the house watching basketball games and baseball games, and then I also start looking around the house and noticing some paint on the wall might have cracked, or you might see some scuffs on the wall, and you want to get that updated. If that's the case at your house, you need to get Serta Pro Painters on the case today. SertaPro.com, that's Serta with a C. All you have to do is go to their website, and they will come over, give you a free estimate, and you can trust them to get the job done right, because they take pride in what they do. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. When it comes to choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
If you are looking for a safe and loving home for you or your loved one, visit Heartland Rehabilitation and Care Center. Just 15 minutes from Little Rock in Benton, our skilled nursing staff is dedicated to providing quality long-term care and short-term therapy. Visit HeartlandRehabCenter.com. You can call Heartland home.
Have questions about retirement, investments, or your money? Call our financial hotline. Dial 501-381-5228 and leave a voicemail with your specific financial question, and our experts will answer it on the Get Ready for the Future show Saturday mornings at 10 a.m. Get your financial questions answered by the pros. 501-381-5228. Call now. Securities offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA, SIPC. Investment advice offered through Independent Advisor Alliance. Independent Advisor Alliance and GenWealth Financial Advisors are separate entities from LPL Financial.
Tito's Handmade Vodka presents the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Register your 4-person team at 1037thebuzz.com. Brought to you in part by Lion Legal.
Out of Bounds with Joe Franklin and Wes Moore on 1037 The Buzz.
Back to Out of Bounds, Wes Moore, Joe Franklin on this Monday, April Fool's Day, by the way. Be on the lookout. My wife is, this is like one of her favorite holidays, so I'm always on the edge of my seat. Phone rings from her. I'm like, all right, what's she going to try? Hey, I just saw this. We had somebody on the Southern Structural Solutions text line last week ask us about Michi Johnson from South Carolina. They're like, you think Arkansas would go? Think of a Savage maybe asked about Michi Johnson. Well, this is from Joe Tipton. South Carolina's Michi Johnson has heard from the following schools since entering the portal: Kentucky, Ohio State, Arkansas, and Texas A&M. Not a surprise that Arkansas reached out. I think they reach out to about 50%. It seems like out of the thousands in the portal, Arkansas reaches out to about half of them. But at least there's been some contact, and Arkansas shown some interest in Michi Johnson. Like him, I'll take Michi. Let's talk a little Razorback football. Oh, and then we got Kirby. Kirby, hang in there with us. Can't wait to talk to Kirby. He was one of our winners. He went to the game. Curtis Wilkerson joins us now. Let me pull him up, turn this music down. Sorry, Curtis, it's a Monday, and I'm still trying to get into the flow of things. Curtis Wilkerson now with us, Natty State Sports. What's up, man? How are you?
Hey, I'm doing good, and don't sweat it. I've always got a case of the Mondays, even if it's a different day of the week. So I get it, my man.
Let's just start with the scrimmage on Saturday. Impression of the scrimmage, what'd you see?
I got to tell you, I kind of feel like I saw exactly what I needed to see. You know, the first team offense comes out. They have back-to-back touchdown drives, so, you know, you like to see it. Taylen Green looked good there. He had a nice touchdown pass to Luke Haz, who looks good. Jaquindon Jackson, the transfer running back out of Utah, had a nice run, 10-yard touchdown run. So the offense was looking really good early, but you know how it is when you're scrimmaging each other. You're like, okay, well, what does that say about the defense?
Yep.
But really from that point forward, I thought they really tightened up. They started to string together some stops. They went into some red zone and some goal line work a little bit later in the scrimmage, and the defense, I thought, really dominated those periods. So you had some good stuff with your offense sustaining some drives early. The defense picked it up late. And I think if you were able to kind of script out what you want to see in a spring scrimmage, that's probably about right. Wasn't all perfect. I mean, they had probably more penalties than Sam Pittman would have liked them to have. I think they had 11 total. But you're going to see that early on in the spring. Miscommunications here and there, but they kept the ball off the ground for the most part. Not a lot of turnovers, not a lot of busted assignments. So overall, I mean, probably a little bit better than I expected, to be honest with you.
What did you see from the quarterbacks as a whole, not only Taylen Green, but Malachi Singleton, Jacoby Criswell?
Yeah, Green was it was a little bit of a roller coaster for him. I thought he started really strong, was making some good throws. He had a nice throw to Haz. Later, he connected with Batania for a pretty long touchdown pass. He had a string there in the middle section where his accuracy got away from him a little bit on some short throws to the running backs and intermediate plays there. But he picked it up towards the end. I think he finished about 10 of 21. So he'd like to get that a little bit higher. But for the most part, he was in command of the offense. Thought he looked fine. Looking at some of those other guys, you know, Criswell, it was kind of a quiet day for him. He was 8 of 14 for 60 yards. Wasn't really throwing the ball downfield too much. I got to tell you, though, Singleton and K.J. Jackson really both impressed me for maybe different reasons. Singleton just seems like, you know, between him and Green, the offense feels like it flows. It's just in a little bit better rhythm than it is with some of those other guys. He's got good command of it. He doesn't put the ball in harm's way, makes the throws that he needs to make, and when it's not there, he can tuck it and run that thing. He was 9 of 13 for 91 yards, so it's pretty solid there. When you look at a guy like K.J. Jackson as a freshman, man, he really looks the part, lefty, tall and athletic. Man, he was 7 of 9 for 58 yards, but he had a couple throws where he really, really thread the needle. He's got a good ball. A guy that's probably not going to make a lot of noise this year because he's got some other dudes in front of him. But, man, I think Arkansas's really got a bright future with K.J. Jackson there. But, yeah, I think Green was fine, probably not his best. Singleton, I thought, was really sharp. Jackson, really good. And it just wasn't a lot there from Criswell.
Curtis Wilkerson joins us on Out of Bounds. He's with Natty State Sports. Curtis, for those who haven't seen Green play in person, can you compare him to some other quarterback you've seen before?
Man, that's a good question. I mean, he has the Matt Jones look about him, just in terms of being so tall and long and rangy. He's probably every bit of that 6'6", and has a good frame and knows how to use it. I think he's probably going to make more plays with his feet than people let on. You know, he's a guy who ran for quite a few yards at Boise State over the course of his career. I like the way he throws, moving outside the pocket. He's got a really good command, really good feel for the offense. And when you see him, he looks like an SEC quarterback. He's kind of got an aura about him. He's there from a physical standpoint. So really, really, really like what I see from him. I think he's a good fit for what Bobby Petrino is looking for in the offense there. And, we'll see how the season progresses. But, yeah, I mean, he definitely looks the part.
We know how important receivers are in the Bobby Petrino offense. So what do the receivers look like as a whole?
Yeah, and that's one thing I probably should have mentioned a little bit earlier. Andrew Armstrong did not participate in the scrimmage. He's obviously the number one target, but he pulled up a little bit lame on Thursday during practice. Sam Pittman said it was a hamstring. He was out there doing some things. He was doing some of the individual drills. He was running laps and doing some conditioning. He just didn't go through the live stuff. So he was out. Jaden Wilson, who's been running with the ones quite a bit also throughout the course of the spring, he was out also. Kind of without a couple of your top targets there, but they were still able to make some plays. I continue to be really, really impressed with Tyrone Broden. 6'7", he's one of the fastest guys on the team. So you look at him, you're like, okay, this dude could be a serious target. He had his moments last year, but he just looks so much more comfortable this spring than he did really the entire season last year. He's put on some good weight. He's been making some crazy catches. He absolutely mossed the guy in the scrimmage the other day. So I think he's really emerging as a guy who's going to help him a lot. We've talked so much about Isaiah Satania and, are they going to be able to find ways to use him? How can you get him in space? How can you get him touches and targets? I think Petrino's system is a perfect type of system for a guy like Satania. he looked really good. He had that touchdown catch that I mentioned earlier. He had four receptions for about 75 yards. So I really like some of the things they got going on at receiver. And then just in pass catchers in general, when you have a Luke Haas at tight end who's just picking up right where he left off, obviously, Tyrus Washington is a guy who's coming back off of injury, so we haven't seen much of him yet, but you know what he's capable of. But Barkley's gums. I mean, the tight end, the transfer out of North Texas, who probably didn't meet expectations last year, I think you're starting to see what you thought you were going to get out of him. He's been really, really good, just kind of flying under the radar this spring. He had a couple of nice plays in that scrimmage, too. So when it comes to weapons for them to get the ball out to, I think they got plenty of them in the pass-catching game.
Curtis Wilkerson joins us from Natty State Sports. Curtis, what about the offensive line?
I think they're better, I really do. They look like a connected group out there, especially that first unit. I really like the mix that they have there with the three transfers and Blackstock and Nichols especially have been pretty impressive out there, and then Carmona also. And then you mix in the two returners in Braun and Kudus. It's a formidable group. They look the part, and they've really, really looked solid so far. I thought the backs had a really good day on Saturday, playing behind that first team offensive line. I like their physicality. I like their swagger. It just has a little bit of a different feel and a different vibe this season. Eric Mateos, he is he's a very animated guy in practice, so a lot of fun being able to hang out there and listen to some of the things that he has to say. But Sam Pittman's been spending a ton of time down there, too. I think he even said during one of the press conferences he's kind of serving as a GA for the offensive line for Eric Mateos when they're in individual drills. And I think you're starting to see that pan out, too. So I really like what they've got going on with that first group. And the question is always, how much depth do you have? And we'll see. I mean, there's a noticeable drop-off when you go to the twos and threes. That should be expected. But we're the guys that are going to be able to rotate in and out of there. I think, you know, Amari Wiggins is probably a guy to watch at center who could provide some depth for him. Amarian Harris is a guy that they've been excited about. Maybe it's his time to shine a little bit. And then Tykeus Crawford, I mean, it feels like he's been there for a decade now, and maybe a guy that you can lean on at those tackle spots. So we'll see how the depth plays out. But in terms of the front five there, I really, really like what they have going on. Seems like an improved group over last year. We're just kind of have to see how it plays out over the fall and then get into the season.
Let's take a look at the defense, starting with the defensive line.
Yeah, you know what? I tell you what, when you've got a guy like Landon Jackson back, that's a pretty good place to start. He's picked up right where he's left off. Been really, really impressed with Cam Ball. I think he's going to have a great year on the interior. You got some reliable guys in TV Rose. Eric Gregory, you know, guys that you know you can count on. And then just looking at some of the other pass rushers, I've really been waiting to see something from Albany transfer Anton Junkaj. This is a guy who led, you know, the SDS in sacks. It's just kind of been a quiet spring for him. Hasn't stood out in a bad way, but certainly hasn't done much in a positive way where he's really jumped off the page. I thought he had a great scrimmage on Saturday. Every time I looked up, he was in the backfield. Obviously, you can't hit the quarterback, but he got back there and got a couple touchbacks, was in the backfield disrupting things, making some TFLs, some solo tackles. So he's a guy that I think if he really can step up and be what they thought he could be, that's going to help him a lot. I do think when this next transfer portal window opens up here soon, you could add a little bit of depth there, especially maybe on the interior. But for the most part, the defensive line is looking pretty solid with that front group.
Defensive back, is that the deepest position on the defense?
Yeah, it might be, man. They've got plenty of them for sure. You know, Jalen Braxton, I think, has looked really impressive there. Hudson Clark, old reliable, has been back there. Actually, he made an interception to close the scrimmage. He picked off Taylen Green on Saturday, so you love to see that. But, they've got a lot of bodies there. It's a talented group. They're athletic. I also like some of the size they have with some of the transfers they brought in. You think about, you bring in some SEC transfers, guys from Florida, guys from Tennessee, and they certainly look the part. I would say definitely the deepest part of the defense. I'm fine with what they got on the defensive line. I think you can add a body there. I think if you're really talking about where you probably need to look at making some moves and making some additions, linebacker will be the place on that defense, especially it really stands out.
Yeah, that was my next question. To me, if there's one concern There's an area that maybe after spring practice, when you know everybody else's spring practice is done and guys get back into the portal, I got to think linebacker is something they're going to be targeting. Is that a huge concern to you, or a big concern, or a concern at all?
It's absolutely a concern for me. And you know, Pittman said in the past, like it sometimes is a situation where it's not that you can't play, you just haven't. And I think that's maybe, or at least hopefully, the case that they're running into. They've got some guys there who have some talent and some guys who could really develop and be good SEC linebackers. You saw flashes from Brad Spence last year as a true freshman. And he had the memorable pick six. And he's still a ball hawk, man. It's almost like he gets an interception for practice. So you love to see that. I think you feel pretty comfortable about what you can get from him. Alex Sanford is another guy, a young guy that they're excited about. Didn't get a lot of reps last year. Go into the portal and get a guy like Xavier Story from Georgia. So you got Matt to think, well, from a talent athleticism standpoint, you're probably in a pretty good spot there. And he's looked fine too, but I just think you need more. And I think what they really need to go out and identify, and it's going to be tricky, but they've done it in the past, but they just got to go out and get some guys who've got proven production. And whether that's at the SEC or the power conference level, or you know, maybe one of those mid-major guys who's really racked up the tackle somewhere else. But I think you got to go get a guy who's had a lot of reps and a lot of experience and kind of command that room a little bit. Maybe one you can get by with. And if I was Sam Pittman, I'd probably be looking at it and saying, you know what, we might need to go get a couple bodies here.
Curtis, thanks. It was good to catch up with you. I appreciate the practice report, the scrimmage report.
Absolutely. You guys got it anytime.
All right. Curtis Wilkerson joining us. Thanks to Natty State Sports. Let's go to Kirby. Kirby was also at that scrimmage and won some Razorback tickets from us last week. So how was your weekend, Kirby?
Oh, we had a great weekend. Curtis and them about summed it up. I kind of seen the same thing. The one thing I was concerned about was field goal misses. There was like three or four missed field goals. And to give Green a little bit more credit, they were several drops. I mean, they were just right there in the numbers, and the receivers dropped the ball. But he did really make one good touchdown pass, that they were saying, and he couldn't have put it in no better place. I mean, I thought the defense done a real good job, too. They were swarming the ball, I thought, and the offensive line, they looked better.
Good.
They were actually able to run the ball.
How much fun was the baseball
game?
Yeah,
we had a great it was exciting, man. We went to Sassy's and watched the game before on Friday night, and then I knew it could be a possible sweep. So, yeah, we were pumped up for that game. And in the first swing of the bat of the game was LSU hit it over the fence. And I thought, oh, man, what's this going to happen now? And I thought they were going to home run us to death. They just, kept on coming back. And but it was a great game, man. I enjoyed every bit of it.
Awesome. Man, I'm glad you were able to go and had a big weekend. Kirby, thanks for calling back in, and we'll talk to you soon. We got to take a break. Ran a little bit behind. That was a good interview, though, with Curtis. Got a lot of good information. When we come back, we'll wrap up the first hour. Barry Odom coming up in the second hour. Stick around for that. It's Out of Bounds.
Tito's Handmade Vodka presents the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Registration is now open. Go to 1037thebuzz.com to register your four-person team. Prizes will be awarded in both the morning and afternoon flights. The 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course. Presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka and brought to you in part by Lion Legal, with special thanks to Corky's Ribs and Barbecue, Sonic, and Michelob Ultra.
Make this summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch is all about creating fun on our lakes and rivers. You have to come by and see the new 2024 G3 Tritunes, the hottest and coolest ride out there. We're easy to find. Take the Levy exit.
This is the Pigskin Preacher, bringing you the word. Few entertainers are as interesting and enigmatic as Andre 3000. The former rapper from Outkast was responsible for the wildly catchy Hey Ya in 2003. He also starred in Will Ferrell's Semi-Pro as the Flint Tropics basketball star Sugar Dunkerton and Coffee Black. These days, he is pursuing a solo career in experimental music, on which he plays a variety of flutes. Andre remains a radical chameleon of music and style, getting his ideas across even without using words. If Andre 3000 came to Arkansas, he would come to Doubleby's for some delicious bean-to-cup Rinoco coffee, any way he wants it. Coffee black, with cream, cappuccino, or whatever he would choose. And whatever you would choose. Doubleby's. It's where you gas it, grab it, and go. That's Doubleby's.
Razorback pitcher Will McIntyre joins Morning Mayhem each week, presented by Seth Boyd with Shelter Insurance. Give Seth a call for all your insurance needs at 501-982-6465.
Tackle your outdoor projects with Greenway Equipment's Lawn Patrol Package. Handling is effortless with the John Deere 1023E's Twin Touch Foot Controls with a hydrostatic transmission and four-wheel drive with power steering. The 60D Driveover Auto Connect Belly Mower makes mowing easy. And the 120R Quick Park Loader is perfect for dirt moving and mulching projects. With 0% APR for 84 months and a 6-year powertrain warranty, it's a deal you can't miss. For more information, head to your local Greenway or visit gogreenway.com. With approved credit, see dealer for details.
The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics. Hey, everybody, it's RJ Hawk. You know, I've been talking about this for a long time, and I say the future's here. You just haven't tried it yet. If you've got achy joints that have been nagging you for a long time, don't go to a doctor and have them recommend surgery or drugs. Go by and give QC Kinetics a try today for a free consultation. They are the nation's leader in the most exciting revolution in pain management we've seen in decades. It's called regenerative medicine. If your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. We're talking natural biologics using your own body's power to repair and restore your damaged tissue. QC Kinetics is under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Shinecup. He is a pioneer in the field with 20 years of clinical work, tons of research, teaching, and publishing. Call QC Kinetics now to learn about these exciting options. It's a free consultation. 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440.
Hey everyone, this is Heather Baker, president and publisher of AY Media Group here in Arkansas. We publish two of the biggest and most widely read magazines in the entire state, AY Magazine and Arkansas Money and Politics. At AY and Arkansas Money and Politics, we keep you up to date on all the news you need to know and the stories you want to hear. Visit us online at aymag.com and armoneyandpolitics.com to see for yourself. Now, more than ever, it is important to be mindful of where you get your news and support your local businesses. With AY Media Group, you get the best of both worlds.
Weekend recap brought to you by Fleet Management Services, serving Central Arkansas for over 20 years. They're your small to mid-sized specialist. When you need someone to service your fleet and get your employees back on the road quick, call 501-375-3672.
It was a great weekend with the Diamond Hogs sweeping LSU. Razorback scrimmage, A-State scrimmage too, by the way. Got the Final Four set, UConn, Alabama, North Carolina State, and Purdue. You got a little bit of everything. You got a team looking for back-to-back titles, and you got a Cinderella in there. And then you got Zach Edey, a big 7'4" center, and an SEC team in Alabama that maybe if you were picking SEC teams to go to the Final Four, they would have been your third or fourth pick, safe to say. I think Tennessee, Kentucky, Auburn, Alabama.
Yeah. But they're the team that got there. Got it done.
They did, man. They shot the ball well the other night, man. The threes were raining. That was a fun game, back and forth game. They were down 13, came storming back with an 11-0 run. They look good. They're shooting the ball well.
Now they go against the monster in UConn.
Yeah. It's going to be tough. Very tough. All right, coming up next, Barry Odom will join us after the Razor Hog update. We'll get his thoughts on spring practice for UNLV, riding a bull, and some of his Arkansas kids on the team. Stick around. Hour 2's next.
You can hear the best of the NCAA tournament on 106.7 Buzz 2 from the very beginning all the way to the championship game. March Madness on 103.7 The Buzz and 106.7 Buzz 2.
Some people aren't easily inspired. They require a little more craftsmanship, more elegance, more excitement. Some people are inspired and see the future before it's here. They see the GV70 for its selection as a Car and Driver 10 Best, GV80 for its soft quilted leather, reclining and heated second row seats, and for its IIHS top safety rating. What inspires you? The all-new Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today.
Chosen as one of Arkansas's best places to work 8 years in a row, Rainwater Holden Sexton is hiring premier paralegals and legal assistants with an emphasis on bilingual Spanish-speaking candidates at all locations. Rainwater Holden Sexton's mission is to compassionately represent injured and disabled Arkansans. With generous benefits and competitive pay, Rainwater Holden Sexton is a destination employer hiring the best. We're also seeking bilingual Spanish-speaking attorneys to join our team. Apply today at callrainwater.com.
Get your popcorn ready. We've got the entertainment right here on 103.7 The Buzz. KABZ Little Rock. Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
A Little Rock student has a big decision to make after being accepted to 16 universities, including four Ivy League schools. Nora Ali is a senior at Pulaski Academy in Little Rock and president of the student council. She's been accepted to 16 different schools like Harvard, Columbia, Cornell, NYU, Rice, UCLA. The list goes on and on top of receiving a full ride to UMKC Medical School. Congratulations to Nora. The University of Central Arkansas is collaborating with the Arkansas Department of Education to collect data during the upcoming solar eclipse. UCA designed 250 circuit boards that they'll distribute to 60 schools in 45 Arkansas counties. They'll measure light, speed, temperature, and even sounds during that event. UCA will use the data for future projects and student research. And don't forget to tune in to Channel 7 News live coverage of the eclipse on Monday, April 8th. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Mark your calendars for the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBQ, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Tickets on sale soon.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Cloudy to mostly cloudy skies today. Rather warm with a high around 79 and windy too. Tonight we've got some rain and thunderstorms moving across the state. Those could be strong to severe, especially across northwestern Arkansas. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Hi, I'm Trey Reed from the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission, inviting you to join me every Wednesday morning for the latest news from the great outdoors. It's brought to you by Arts Marine in North Little Rock, now under new ownership, but with the same familiar faces and incredible service you've known for years, plus the area's best selection of boating parts and supplies.
Are you someone who tries to drive while distracted by your phone? Someone who props it up on the steering wheel or peeks down at it for a glance? Or just scrolls and scrolls? If so, you could be the next person to get into a fender bender, get a ticket, veer off the road, or even cause a crash that kills you or someone else. Enough with the phones already. Put them down and pay attention, or pay the price. You drive, you text, you pay. Paid for by NHTSA.
Riceland Foods in Stuttgart is hiring a shift supervisor, a plant engineer, plant electrician, I&E technician, and packaging tech. Riceland Foods company benefits include medical insurance with low premiums, free dental with medical enrollment, vision insurance with low premiums, free basic life insurance up to 3 times basic annual earning, voluntary term life, long-term disability, short-term disability, accident insurance, critical illness insurance, 401k with company match 4% of employees 5%, paid training programs, PTO, and paid holidays. Riceland Foods is hiring shift supervisor, a plant engineer, plant electrician, I&E technician, and packaging tech. Get all the information on these jobs and more at Riceland.com. Home to over 1,500 employees, Riceland has a position to match your unique skill set. With so many departments and positions available, the possibilities are endless. For more information on these jobs and more, go to Riceland.com. Riceland, a farmer-owned cooperative, helping farmers feed the world.
Heartland Rehabilitation and Care Center in Benton proudly offers compassionate and loving care to our veterans, meeting the unique needs of every veteran who calls Heartland home. Visit heartlandrehabcenter.com.
The Outlaw is back. That's right. Each Thursday morning at 8 a.m., Tommy Smith visits Morning Mayhem to talk Razorbacks, music, and who knows what else. Tommy Smith is brought to you by Hubbard Power Sports, Can-Am, and Sea-Doo in Russellville. On the road, on the water, and in the trails, they have the ride for you.
And ESPN Radio Extra Point with Myron Medcalf.
Let's just officially call UConn a blue blood, though, because they are. UConn is now in the Kansas, Kentucky, Duke category in basketball.
Listen, if they win this year, this is going to be a number that I don't think people out there have really processed. If they win the title this year, the last 25 NCAA tournaments, 25, they'll have six of them. Six of the last 25. And I think the reason we don't process it, Myron, is two reasons. One, they've only made six Final Fours in that period. So they will have won the title every year they made the Final Four. That's crazy. Like that, just go look historically. That does not happen. So it's weird because they don't feel like a blue blood in some ways. But, Myron, I don't know how you can argue they're not.
Are you over 30 and putting off life insurance? It's time to get a quick quote from Ethos, a better, easier way to get term life insurance, all online with no medical exam. Answer a few health questions and you could be approved for up to $2 million. Isn't it worth 10 minutes to help protect your family's financial security? Ethos, up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at checkethos.com. That's checkethos.com.
Planning for spring at Lowe's means big savings on outdoor power equipment. And Lowe's knows nothing feels better than free. Buy one select Ego string trimmer, leaf blower, or mower kit. Get one select 56-volt battery free. That's up to a $299 value. Power through spring with Ego, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power. Because Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 4/3 while supplies last. Selection varies by location.
Live from the Signal Media Studios, this is Out of Bounds with Wes Moore and Joe Franklin on 103.7 The Buzz. It's time for your Razor Hog update on Out of Bounds. Brought to you by Floyd's Seafood, Keel Avenue in Sherwood. It's crawfish season. Floyd's Seafood has live and cooked crawfish. Order yours today.
Here's the pitch. White swings, hard ground ball, base hit down the third baseline, and Edmondson's off to the races. He's on his way to third. Larson in the left field corner has trouble with it. They're going to try to score. Edmondson, he's on his way home. The Hogs win! Head first to the plate. Hudson White wins it with an RBI double, and the Razorbacks win it 4-3.
That was game two on Friday night, and then Arkansas gets the sweep on Saturday. Will McIntyre, big reason why, pitching two of the three games.
Well, that's one reason we put him in there, because he's older, he's been there, and really doesn't get rattled. And, you know, he just came in there and kind of did what he does. You know, just excited to, for him. He's really having a good year for us, and he's been Mr. Reliable. And, you know, I didn't write his name on the board. I didn't write it on the lineup card. And when I went, and I always post a lineup card down by the locker room, when I went and got it right before we go out stretch, his name just appeared on there because I guess he wrote it in there. So I said something to Coach Hobb and he said, yeah, he wrote it in there. And we didn't want him doing much. And I guess he threw 24 pitches and that was all he needed to throw right there. So glad it worked out.
It worked out. Arkansas gets the sweep over LSU. Arkansas number one in D1 baseball rankings. LSU, by the way, fell to number 18 after getting swept by the Razorbacks. Arkansas softball in action tonight against Georgia, trying to win that series. They won game one. Georgia won game two. So game three tonight on the SEC Network. That would be huge because Georgia's ranked number three in the country. So that would be a great road series for the Arkansas women. And then the Arkansas women's golf team won a golf tournament over the weekend. They're a top 10 team. And the Arkansas football team, of course, we just discussed the scrimmage, the big scrimmage they had on Saturday. We're going to talk some more football right now. Joining us on Out of Bounds is Barry Odom, Razorbacks former defensive coordinator, now the head coach at UNLV. Coach, it's good to catch up with you. How are you?
Hey, man, I hope you're doing great, buddy. Thanks so much for having me on. Always good to connect in places we've been before, and there's a lot going on, obviously, with our program, and I know at Arkansas as well. I got a chance to catch the Hogs play the other night when they played LSU, and Baum looked on fire, as it always is. We got so many great memories of living there the 3 years, and one of them was being out in the Hog Pen for one of the night games on the weekend series, and what makes some of that area so special is the fan base and how important Razorback sports are, and I was sure excited and proud to be a part of it.
So, Coach, when you're watching that baseball game the other night, are you still rooting for Arkansas to win that game? Coach, you there? We lost Coach. That was quick. Did I offend him? I don't think so. We'll get him back on here. Barry Odom, and I was counting on during the break, I counted 9 players from the state of Arkansas or with ties to Arkansas on the team, UNLV. So it's kind of a team outside of the state of Arkansas. It's got more connections than anybody else I would bet in the country. Let's try him again. Coach, we lost you there for a second. I was asking you, when you were watching that LSU-Arkansas game, are you still rooting for Arkansas? Were you hoping they would win that game?
Oh, heck yeah. I mean, the Razorbacks, they're my team for always. I mean, our 3 years there, you know, I tell people, and very truthful and honest, that the best place that myself and my family has ever lived. We kept our house there. Everything about Northwest Arkansas we loved, and in a great geographic location of where my family is in Oklahoma, and my wife's family in Missouri, and we had a boat out on Beaver Lake, and it was hard to leave because it's such, you know, the people of the state and the fan base are unmatched, and I respect that greatly, and was honored to have a small piece of that time in my coaching life for those 3 years we were there.
Coach, wherever you go, you keep those connections and players seem to follow. You have good relations with the players. What's the key to relations with players these days in the game and how it is?
You know, I think everybody, and to an extent, it's true, everybody thinks and talks about how much the game has changed, and it has. But it's always changing. I mean, you always, you know, there's new rules, there's new legislation, all kinds of different things that the game looks different. But at the end of the day, I'm in the business and have been for 20 plus years now on helping young men achieve great success. I want them to graduate from college with a meaningful degree. We make the connection with people that will help them for the next 40 to 50 years of their life. And then I want them to all strive to be the best players they can be on the field and ultimately have an opportunity to play in the NFL. And it's relationship driven. And the only way you can have a real relationship, it takes time and it takes effort. And you've got to pour into your players, and you've also got to educate them, and you've got to be real with them on what they're doing really well, what they need to do to improve. And then also, you got to be there with them every step of the way. And if you do that, you're truthful, you're open, and you're honest, then you don't have to force a relationship. It happens. And, you know, I've learned a long time ago, I'm I'm a really, really good coach with great players. And so you want to recruit guys that fit systematically on what you want to do, but also culturally on what your locker room looks like. Recruiting is all hands on deck to try to get it done every day to make your program better. And then once you get guys in the building and in your program, you know, the relationship part of that never stops. We had a scrimmage this last weekend, and I had, we had over 500 prospects and their families here on campus, but then also had five former players that I coached that are coaching somewhere else now that just came and spent the weekend with us to watch our teams compete and practice. And, you know, those things, relationships never go away, and it's so important.
We're talking with Barry Odom, head coach at UNLV. He joins us on Out of Bounds. Coach, I just scanned your roster, and I think I counted, I may have missed somebody, but I counted nine players from the state of Arkansas, either from the state, played at Arkansas, UCA, on your roster. How are some of those guys doing? I was a big Kylan James fan. I covered a lot of UCA football and watched their games. Just how are some of those guys doing for you?
I think you always go back, and obviously we're going to recruit the city of Vegas. There's 36 high schools in the city here and they play great ball. That's geographically where we start our recruiting blueprint. And then we get into California because of how the proximity of how close it is, and Phoenix. And then for me, I go back to my roots on where I know coaches and have relationships with over the years and have built trust in what that looks like. The state of Arkansas has always been great to me in recruiting. Look at Kansas City area in Missouri for my time there as a head coach, and then into Dallas and Houston. And, you know, for today's world, recruiting is, we're a national brand. You can get a direct flight from just about anywhere in the United States to Vegas, and we embrace that. And I think the experiences that I had at Arkansas, there's some guys that, you know, decided to go extend their career somewhere else and look differently, and had a chance to reunite with some of those guys. And then, you know, you mentioned Kylan James from Central Arkansas. You know, had a great career at Dumas, and known the coaching staff there for a long time. And he decided he was going to transfer, and he's had a terrific spring. And, you know, last year offensively, for us, we led the country in rushing touchdowns up until the bowl game. And then Georgia put 69 or whatever they did on Florida State. They passed us in the rushing category in bowl season. But we're going to run the football. And I think Kylan's got a huge part in that. His role will continue to grow. And as we get through spring practice here next weekend and into fall camp, he's got a chance to really help our offense continue to improve.
How has spring practice been so far with some of the returning players and then some of the additions you added to the team?
You know, you can look at on what you did last year and how you can build and move that forward. For us, we won nine games, won the conference, regular season conference championship, and something that hadn't been done here in over 40 years. And that was a really good start for us. But that doesn't mean and translate into the same thing this year. So we were a really young team last year on paper. So I think one of the marks of last year's team is we got better every single game. We just continually moved the needle forward, and we're a better football team every single week. So that doesn't just magically happen this year. We've got to make it happen. So the challenge and the charge of our coaching staff is anybody that played last year, we've got to coach better, number one. They've got to play better. And then the new faces that we have in the program, we've got to get them galvanized on the same page. And if we do that, then we've got a chance to put together another really good run. Our schedule is a tough one for us. We open up at Houston. Week three, we go to Kansas. Week four, Syracuse comes here. And then we play our conference schedule, which is Boise and Air Force and Fresno and all the different people that make up the Mountain West Conference. It will be a very difficult schedule, and we understand that, you know, we've got to control us and keep moving things forward, because in my scope and view on things, UNLV football should be a national brand, and it hasn't been. But there's too many opportunities here of a city of 2.5 million people. It's the sports mecca of the United States, and there's enough space for college football to be successful here.
We're talking with Barry Odom. And, Coach, when I Googled your name, this comes up. Barry Odom takes a vicious hit while riding bull to raise money. UNLV football coach gets wrecked riding bull to raise money. What in the world were you thinking when you said yes?
Well, there's a number of things that go into that. Number one, I will do anything for my football team. I mean, if we've got a chance to, in a time of the year, which over the course of the last 40 years, there hasn't been a lot of news about UNLV football this time of year. An opportunity to raise money, guaranteed money that we can use in the space of our football program, whether NIL or facility improvements. And then there was guaranteed money on top of that. If I stayed on it for long enough, a couple guys in town in the city were going to match it. So they reached out to me and asked if I would consider it. And I said, no, not interested. And then they started talking about what it would look like and what we could do and how it would improve our program. And so I started to listen. And then in a very, very weak moment, I said, yeah, sure, I'll go do that. But they told me I was going to be on an old cow that had been put out to pasture and I wouldn't have to really worry about it. And then I got in the chutes that night and they said, all right, coach, you're up in four. And I started counting back four bulls. I was like, wait a minute, this looks a little bit different than kind of what I had in my mind. And I tried to get as many pointers and coaching tips as I could leading up to it about riding a bull. And as soon as I got on the thing and it went in a full body flex, I knew I was in big time trouble. And when they opened the gate, all those coaching points went straight out the window. I was just trying to survive. And I didn't last very long, but it was we raised a lot of money and I used it for our team the next morning. We had practice the next day. We went through it step by step. They got a good laugh out of it. And luckily, I was able to walk away and survive.
You do any training leading up to it? Did you try a mechanical bull ahead of time, or you just went all in?
I just went all in. I mean, I've got a little bit of a workout routine I do, but it would not be confused for training to ride a bull.
You've taken some big hits in your life playing football, I'm sure. Well, how did this compare, that hit from the bull?
Well, luckily, it was a glancing blow. Had it been direct, I probably would have been in trouble. But it knocked the breath out of me, so when I stood up, I was – out of breath. And I realized at the age of 47 things feel a little bit different than they did when I was 22 or 21, but we've got a level of toughness in our program, and I tried to use that for our team about just another standard of how we're going to go approach things. We're going to go all in.
So, Coach, you were talked into this. Some people view this as something bucket list. Do you have any other things that are bucket list for you?
It was not on my bucket list ever. and I can say with pretty strong conviction, I will not be on another bull.
What if they raise the ante next year? You know, that competition comes around every year.
Then I'll probably, me well enough through competitive spirit, I'll probably say yes.
Yeah, you got to beat that. Well, how long did you stay on?
I don't know. I've heard there's a number of different reports out there, and it's from not very long to embarrassingly really short. So all much respect for guys that do that on a weekly basis. It's a different world.
So where you guys are in spring practice, Coach, where do you go from here, and what are you trying to see next? What do you want to improve on even more?
So tomorrow we will have – this week we go Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday as our spring game. So we've got three really good days left. I like what we've got accomplished so far. Tomorrow is a huge day in the development of our team with some situations that we're going to go through in practice. And then Thursday we're going to use just like a normal Thursday in season – how those Thursday practices look with the kicking script and kind of down to the minute on what that looks like. And then Saturday we'll go, we play in Allegiant Stadium, which is one of the finest football facilities in the world. We'll have our spring game there and have a number of high-level recruits on campus. We'll go for about 2 hours of scrimmaging against each other. And then, for us, on the way that our program is designed, I want to have four really good weeks of a cycle in the weight room So we'll go 4 weeks in the weight room. Our kids will have finals. They'll get out of town for a couple of weeks, and then we start with summer ball. And, you know, for us as a staff, it's trying to keep this roster together with the portal window opening. And then we'll be very, very aggressive across the country and going and attacking what the 2025 recruiting class will look for us and what it'll look like as the roster management piece continues to grow. And, you know, we've been a high school recruiting team, but we've all also have taken a number of high-level transfers. And, you know, the ability to blend those together and for their culture to fit in the way that it should in your locker room, it's a never-ending process that really I enjoy. And, you look at, you know, there's a number of people that complain about the portal and you know, there's good and bad with everything, and everybody celebrates when you get a player, and then, you know, they say it's the worst thing ever when you lose one. Our charge as a staff is if we happen to lose a player, then we've got to go upgrade and find somebody that is a great fit and is a better player. So I'm excited about the opportunities we've got coming up here, and I really like what the foundation of our 2024 team looks like right now. It'll be a sprint to try to get as good as we can, and I look forward to it.
UNLV football coach Barry Odom is with us on Out of Bounds. Coach, speaking of the portal, the Razorbacks got a quarterback out of the portal, and Taylen Green has been taking pretty much the majority of the snaps with the first-team offense. I know you know about Taylen Green. Can you give us a scouting report?
He is a talented player in every area. Throws really well. Dynamic in the run game. Physically can do a number of things. He's got elite arm talent, in my opinion. I think he can stretch the field in a number of different ways, not only in the pass game, but running the ball. You know, I saw it up close and personal in the championship game for us. And then with the opportunity for him to be coached by Bobby, I think that his career is about to take off. And, you know, we were able to hire Coach Petrino here when I first got the job. He was my offensive coordinator for about 8 days, and sure hated to lose him, but because he's one of my good friends, and I knew when I got this job, he was my number one target to try to go higher. And, you know, we got it done, and then A&M called, and things changed. But I know that they'll have great success with his development in the quarterback room, and I look forward to watching it.
There's another quarterback I want to ask you about. The Fayetteville Purple Dogs are the defending state champs here in Arkansas. You know anything about this Garrett Odom, this quarterback that transferred in?
I know, luckily for him, he looks and acts like his mom and has her athletic ability, so he's got a chance. I think, you know, I mentioned earlier about our love of the state, and, you know, for kids, they consider that home. And, you know, when we ended up moving, we kept our house there. So, really, I kind of feel like I'm commuting back and forth. You know, so he's going to finish up being around his friends his senior year, and he's certainly excited about that and the opportunity. He started back there in January, and he's excited about what they've got going. And I don't know how my wife's going to do it. She's going to make all his games and then make our games as well, because we've got another son that's a freshman linebacker here for UNLV, and so she's going to try to see them all, and hopefully I can make a couple as well.
Coach, you mentioned playing in Allegiant Stadium, and the city of Vegas hosts big events all the time. There was a Super Bowl, the NFL draft. It's been an NCAA tournament host site. Did you go to the Super Bowl, and what have those events been like for the city?
Yeah, the city is always there's something going on, some main event always, whether it's you know, a boxing match, whether it's the NASCAR race, the NASCAR South Point 400, whether it's F1 race that was here, the Super Bowl you mentioned, we had the Pro Bowl last year. Our facility, we hosted the 49ers this year for the Super Bowl. So they took over our facilities for about a week, and the experience that we gained through that, working with the NFL, it was great for our program and put us on the map in a lot of different ways, and good for our kids to see. I had three players on the Chiefs that I coached back when I was a head coach at Missouri and an assistant there. So, I was sure rooting for them and glad it turned out for them to be world champs. But But again, you know, the stadium, and I would imagine that Allegiant, our stadium will be, you know, at some point it'll be put on the natural rotation of hosting the Super Bowl because of the great venue. And then Vegas is built to host something that's grand as the Super Bowl. So we're in a really cool spot building this program and all the access and all the opportunities that are here in the city. It's a great time to be here.
Coach, this was a lot of fun. I really appreciate your time, and we'll be rooting for UNLV and all your guys. Thanks a lot.
I appreciate it, guys. Y'all take care.
Barry Odom joining us on Out of Bounds, head coach there at UNLV. That's cool. I mean, I always like – I never got it when Missouri got rid of him. I was like, what are you doing? That's a good coach. And then when he came to Arkansas as a DC, I loved it, his time here. I hated to lose him, but I get it. You know, he's got a chance to be a head coach. And you start hearing about everything that they have there at UNLV and the plan and trying to make it a national school, you know, a fixture in football. And they've got the resources. I'll be rooting for those guys.
It's a great place to be, as he mentioned. And then players, they just really connect with them. And you can see that in coming to Arkansas, Missouri players automatically, you knew that that was a chance that they were going to get in the portal and come here to Arkansas. And then even being there in Vegas with all the amenities around, he still has those connections.
I went down the roster. I saw Ladarius Bishop, Kylan James, Jordan Hanna, Jalen St. John, Jalen Catalan. I forgot he went there. Malik Chavis, Landon Rogers from Parkview, Manny Powell, and Jackson Woodard, Little Rock Christian Academy, all on the UNLV roster. So big connection there of guys, team to root for outside of the state. Hey, we'll open things up when we come back, 661-1037. You want to jump in here on a Monday, take a look back at what happened over the weekend, whether it's Razorback baseball, NCAA tournament, NCAA women's tournament tonight. Two really good games. Phone lines are open. Join us. It's Out of Bounds.
Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse presents Match Game on Morning Mayhem. Listen for your chance to play their version of the classic TV game show. Brought to you by Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse, Arkansas's truck accessory headquarters for over 30 years. Call 501-568-0040 today or click online at arkansastruck.com.
This is SportsCenter.
Arkansas baseball swept LSU over the weekend, winning Thursday's game 7-4, Friday's game 4-3 in 10 innings, and then Saturday's game 7-5. Peyton Stovall has been crucial to Arkansas' success since his return. He went 7-13 at the plate against the Tigers this weekend with one home run and five RBIs. In 14 games, he has four home runs and 17 RBIs while having a .364 batting average and a .446 on-base percentage. He's also been perfect fielding the ball. Arkansas is 23-3 on the season. Their next game is tomorrow against Arkansas State at 6 p.m. And speaking of Arkansas State, former Razorback Joseph Pinion announced his commitment to the Red Wolves after two seasons in Fayetteville. He joins Darian Ford in Jonesboro. Both were part of the same recruiting class at Arkansas. I'm Christian Weaver with the Buzz Radio Network.
Let me tell you about my friends Carl and Karen.
This place is sus. Let's go to Tunica.
And so they did. And immediately, they became winners.
Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning. Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning.
And not just gaming either. They did spinning, dancing.
Winning.
It's or at the sports
book. Winning.
Or enjoying a world-renowned meal.
Winning.
No matter what you're doing in Tunica, you're always a winner. Learn more at tunicatravel.com.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream. A cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at all Kroger stores and all Walgreens.
It's Justin Angry with Laura Beth from Coffin by Design West, getting you ready for spring. And Laura Beth, let's start with some of the outside options that Coffin by Design West provides for folks who are trying to spruce up their homes this time of the year.
We carry a large selection of in-stock steel products, which include leaf blowers, weed eaters, and lawnmowers.
As far as sprucing up the house for spring cleaning, you have a lot of other options there as well.
We have storage totes, power washers, flower bed tools, planters, fertilizers, all your lawn care needs.
It's Coffin by Design West, out west past Taylor Loop, 14900 Cantor Road, Monday through Saturday, online at kaufmanlumber.com.
Your joint replacement journey starts at Ortho Arkansas with all-in comprehensive joint care by fellowship-trained physicians and a team working all together to support and guide you all the way, from consultation to surgery to beyond recovery. Find relief at Ortho Arkansas. Call 501-500-3500 or schedule a visit today at orthoarkansas.com. That's orthoarkansas.com.
Fellas, if you've been feeling tired and grumpy, noticed a lack of motivation and drive, you may have low T. Low testosterone levels can cause weight gain, loss of muscle mass, and so much more. I recommend Low T Center. That's where I got my levels tested. They make it quick, it's easy to get your levels checked, and it's only $25. And with their on-site lab, you'll get results back in about 25 minutes. Most insurance is accepted for treatment. Go to lowtcenter.com now to book your appointment online. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Out of Bounds with Wes Moore and Joe Franklin on 103.7 The Buzz.
Tell me, do you see her? She's living her life.
10 seconds left. Connect. Ziegler puts up a three. No good. Lawyer the rebound. 5 seconds left. Lawyer will dribble it out. And the next stop on the Purdue Redemption Tour is the Final Four.
Zach, an unbelievable performance by this team, but by you specifically. What was your mentality in this game?
They thought they knew us, man. They thought they knew we had our hearts. I promise you they didn't. We're winners. That's what we do.
Whoa. I missed that. We had the game on. We were doing our Easter egg hunt. I'd never heard that part of it.
Oh, yeah. He was hype and let one slip. But sometimes that happens in the heat of the moment.
I heard the post-game interview last night when I was driving back. And remind me about my drive back and something I heard. Don't let me forget. And they played the clip of him talking about being overlooked. And even said that Rick Barnes had overlooked him. He said, everybody overlooked me. They can't overlook me anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And you could just hear that emotion and how much it meant. And, I mean, this is a guy who came and he's put in the work and made himself a very good college basketball player. And now he's in the Final Four. So good for him. And so that's kind of where that some of that emotion comes from. He was just too much for Tennessee. I thought Tennessee, when they were – man, they were on for a while. They were hitting. Connect was awesome. He had a couple threes back-to-back, and they had a nice little lead, I think 11-point, maybe 12-point at one point during the first half. And then Purdue went on a run. There was just a couple droughts that killed Tennessee, little four-minute droughts where they couldn't score. And Purdue with Edie could always get a good look, a very good look. And they just chipped away. And then Tennessee would get hot again and be right there. Came down to the end. And Connect got a great look, missed it. Purdue, for once, took a three from the outside, knocked it down. And then on the next possession, loose ball, long rebound, and Purdue gets it. Got the scramble, get it to Edie. He is fouled and hit a couple free throws. And I was like, well, that'll do it. That's it right there. Such a close game, back and forth the whole time. And it came down to the very end. Connect misses a three. Purdue hits a three. Tennessee misses, and then Purdue gets a loose ball rebound. Kind of took a good bounce for Purdue. They get the rebound, get it to Edie, gets fouled. And just like that, you know, there's not enough time left. Game's over.
A lot of these games at the end, they've come down to just making a play. And
yeah. A
lot of times that's going to be the difference in a close game where you make a play and you're able to put it away. And we've seen that quite a bit. So it's been good to see some of these close games and just competition at the highest level.
Let's go to Birdman. He joins us now. Birdman, welcome to Out of Bounds.
Hey, fellas. I've had my sports kind of trimmed down on my cable because of financial issues, so I've really depended on the Buzz to kind of keep me informed of what's going on. And it reminds me, I was a kid in the 60s. and that's all we had was radio. So it brought back some pretty cool nostalgia. On the women, I got an opportunity to see both South Carolina and Ohio play, and because they were on, I think, Channel 7 or something.
Yeah.
But anyway, or 11, anyway. The South Carolina team has got some large athletic women. I don't know if I've ever seen a women's basketball team that was that physical and big. And, of course, we know they haven't been beaten. I watched Iowa with Miss Clark, and it was the game against Nebraska where she couldn't hit anything in the first half. But I noticed she was dishing off in the first half. She was doing assists. And she really brought up her defense. In the second half, she started hitting and doing everything else. But I would be, you know, I'm certainly intrigued about the possibility of the two of them playing each other. Hmm. Clark reminds me, I'm old enough to remember, I can't think of his name now, the LSU player that she went past. I'm getting Alzheimer's, guys.
Pete Maravich.
Thank you. She reminds me of him in that, you know, she is so effective at kind of working her guard, whoever's on her, and finding enough space. And then she's in the air, and the ball is gone, and it's like a, it's almost like a fadeaway shot, and just nothing but net. It's very impressive. I'll enjoy that. I want to ask you guys something about the first year Sam was here with the football team. Do y'all remember how in the first few games our defense was had come up with a scheme to overwhelm the receivers, and we were intercepting the football, and we had four or five guys around the receiver, and everybody in the country was talking about this for a while. And I think what happened was, I guess the rest of the teams in the SEC said, okay, they're going to do this. But, you know, do y'all remember that? I think it happened the first 2 years that Sam was here. In the beginning, first two or three games, and everybody was saying, well, what they're doing defensively, as soon as the quarterback lets go of the ball, everybody's running to the ball defensively. A buddy of mine who was in Costa Rica at the time was watching it. He said, they're everywhere. Do y'all remember that?
Yeah. I mean, they had a good defense with Coach Odom as a defensive coordinator. The first,
right.
Yeah, the first couple of years, then just kind of tailed off slowly.
I guess so, yeah. It was very – I mean, we were demoralized. We played – Ole Miss, who had just won, I think, their first or second game of the year and beat a very good SEC team. I can't remember who it was. And we just wiped them out in the second half. The coach was just on his knees. He couldn't believe how many interceptions. But anyway, just in general, appreciate the buzz for keeping me in touch with what's going on. Our baseball team is just freaky right now. I always wanted to be a pitcher. I got to pitch two innings in my Little League career. But it's just got to be a great feeling. If I can get a little more money, guys, I can get my SEC network back on my cable. But anyway, go Arkansas and everything you're doing. And like I said, I'm really intrigued by the women's program this year. I just think it's great basketball.
Yeah, it is. Thanks, Birdman. You got tonight Iowa LSU on ESPN. That's a 6:15 start. And USC Connecticut. I mean, that's a great. I mean, both games. They should have huge ratings for these games.
Well, we've talked about the stars, and the stars are all lined up in these games with Angel Reese, Caitlin Clark, Paige Beckers, Juju Watkins. They're all there on the same night, competing head to head against each other.
And then on the other side of the bracket, you've got South Carolina with the depth and the size, as Birdman was talking, probably the largest team in the NCAA, and then the greatest coach out there, Wes Moore.
How about NC State, though, with both teams, men's and women's teams, in the Final Four?
And both are like 9.5-point underdogs in the Final Four. That role fits them. They were the underdog yesterday. And North Carolina State beat Texas. I don't see the line, but they were the underdog against Texas, and they beat them by 10 yesterday. So, can you imagine being a North Carolina State fan right now?
No, it's a great time.
Yesterday was a great day. Yeah. In fact, when I was driving back, a North Carolina State fan called into a national radio show, and the guy was like, man, I tell you what, you're doing a lot better than I am. If I was a North Carolina State fan, I probably wouldn't be able to talk. I'd had so many drinks celebrating, and you're able to complete your thoughts. Okay, So last time, driving back, this national ESPN radio right here on the Buzz, and they're talking about women's college basketball, and they started talking, got onto the subject of trash talking and how some people don't like it that the women are getting involved in trash. It seems to be okay for a man to talk trash, but for the women, you can't do that. And just some stigma surrounding that, why that is. Well, the talk was very good, and it was informing. DJ called in. Joe. It was 49er John. I know it was 49er John. the speech pattern, the tone, the voice, I recognized it right away, and I'm like, that's 49er John. And at the very end, they said, DJ, thank you for the call, good call. And I was like.
And that called into what show was it?
It was National Talk Show last night, probably about like, I was driving home late last night, probably about 10:30 last night on ESPN Radio. Had to be 49er John. Had to be. I'm serious. Next time he calls, I'm going to ask him.
Maybe giving him.
Do you know
a
his first name?
Too much credit. It's John.
It's John.
Yeah.
It's not like David John is in his middle name, or maybe he just used a moniker, you know, and just said he went with DJ. Had to be him. I thought it was cool though. I was like, that was a good call. He made some really good points. Got in, got out,
and giving him too much credit.
The host agreed with him, and but he kind of agreed with them that look. These women are competing just like men. You know, they're getting after it, and that's what happens in sports. You know, you do a little trash talk. Somebody says something to you. You say something back. That's what goes with competition in sports. And he's like, why should it be any different? And I agree with that. It does not bother me that I see Angel Reese pointing to her ring finger or Caitlin Clark talking some smack. I get it. That's the way it is. It doesn't mean anything different because they're women to me.
It ramps it up even more. It's always been a part of sports, but there's competition there, and that's what it comes down to. Some people compete in different ways where you do it with your play and do it silently,
sure.
And then others, they like to talk trash, and that's across sports.
That's what they said last night. You know, not everybody's Tim Duncan, you know, and just goes out there kind of stoic and doesn't say anything. There are other people out there that have a different way of competing. All right, we got to take a break. When we come back, we'll wrap up the second hour. Coming up later, Joe Klein will be in the studio. We'll talk more about the NCAA tournament with him. Got Razorback baseball we can hit. We'll take some more phone calls when we come back. I see 49er John. We'll find out if that was him when we come back. Stick around. It's Out of Bounds.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Hey there, Arkansas. It's Rowdy Hog Pickleball calling. Are you ready to join in the fun? Discover why pickleball is the fastest growing sport in America. It's an absolute blast for the whole family. Rowdy Hog Pickleball has equipment for all budgets. And here's the best part. Indoor courts are coming soon. And membership is free. Don't miss out on the action. Conveniently located in the outlets of Little Rock. And visit RowdyHogPickleball.com for your free membership.
Spilled your quick, the quicker picker upper. Bounty picks up spills quicker, and each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less than the leading ordinary brand. So you can get back to your night. Bounty, the quicker picker upper.
Progressive presents Good News, Bad News, Dumb News, then Great News. Good news. While leaning over the fence, your neighbor said you could save money bundling home and auto insurance with Progressive. Bad news. Your neighbor leaned over a little too much and broke your fence. Dumb news. Somehow fence wood is more expensive than wood wood. Great news. You decide to see if you could save money bundling at Progressive.com and to plant really tall shrubs. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company affiliates and other insurers not available in all states.
Make this summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch is all about creating fun on our lakes and rivers. You have to come by and see the new 2024 G3 Tritoons, the hottest and coolest ride out there. We're easy to find. Take the Levy exit.
RJ Hawk here with Chris Roberts from Southern Bank. And Chris, you know, we've talked so much about that hometown feel and what it's like at Southern Bank. But if you're a commercial investor, they need to come talk to you.
We're involved with a lot of customers that have projects across the United States. Those projects can be some of the biggest projects you would see in your communities. So really, there's no project that's too large for us to look at.
If somebody's interested in learning more about what Southern Bank can do for their commercial investments, how do they get in touch with you?
You just pick up the phone and call me at 501-424-0900. Just love to talk to you about your project, see what you've got going on, and see how we can be a help to you.
And you talk about being a help. You really invest into your commercial investors by helping them through the process, looking at things to look out for along the way.
I like to think we can throw things off of each other, listen to different viewpoints, and come to the best decision.
If you want to learn more, go online, bankwithsouthern.com, or call Chris, 424-0900, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Tune in each day to Drive Time Sports to hear Trey Biddy talk all things Razorbacks. Brought to you by Chris Crane Hyundai, Arkansas's number one Hyundai dealer, and Genesis of Conway, Arkansas's only Genesis dealer. Genesis of Conway, the future of luxury today.
Yeah. And you say Shy City. Shy City. Shy City.
I'm coming home again. Do you think about me now?
Back at it, Wes Moore, Joe Franklin. Glad you're with us on Out of Bounds on this Monday afternoon when we're looking back and talking about a great weekend. Man, that was a fun weekend. Haven't mentioned the Arkansas Derby. Muth, Baffert gets it done, wins the Arkansas Derby. Gasaway's horse ran third, by the way. Got a bad trip, man. Just an unlucky trip. Horse in front of him. Kind of hit another horse, checked up, and kind of lost his momentum, had to back up a little bit, then use a lot of energy to catch back up. Man, he was passing horses left and right and finished third. And if he doesn't lose those four links, he would have been right there with Muth at the finish, in my opinion. I think he would have been right there. Mystic Dan finished third, so
qualified.
Should get enough points to go to the Kentucky Derby, and I'm not going to keep that horse out of my exotics. I think Mystic Dan's a heck of a horse, and with a better ride at the Arkansas Derby, or just with some better luck, it'd have been right there. Big weekend.
Weekend recap brought to you by Fleet Management Services, serving Central Arkansas for over 20 years. They're your small to mid-sized specialist. When you need someone to service your fleet and get your employees back on the road quick, call 501-375-3672.
Yeah, and if you want to get in here and talk about the weekend, you can join us at 661-1037. Let's go to 49er John and see if we can solve the mystery from last night. Did I hear you on the National Sports Talk show talking about women's basketball last night?
No.
Wasn't
not
you?
At all. No, it wasn't me. No, huh. Now I would have. I mean, don't get me wrong. The women are more captivating than the men this year.
See, that guy said the same thing.
Just be honest.
Yeah, said the same thing.
Tonight's game is the most anticipated game out of the rest of the games, women or men, in my opinion.
It is.
You know?
Yeah, I'm not going to argue that.
It's a rematch of the championship game. They were looking forward to it.
And guys, Before the tournament started, I told you guys I was looking forward to the women more than the men, and it's lived up to it.
I think if we get a UConn-Purdue matchup, that'll be pretty hyped up with Edie and that, you know, a team trying to go back-to-back, trying to stop that, you know, big force inside. I think it's got the potential, but I agree. Tonight's matchup it's one that, you know, heck, I'm a casual fan. I'm excited about tonight.
Oh, man, this is the best game right here. I'm man. Someone is going to have to shut up tonight. Someone. Their whole, you know, them and their fan group, and you know, Caitlin Clark or Angel Reese. Those are the two. You either love those two or you hate them. Ain't no in between between those two. And I love it because it's good for women's basketball. I mean, this is the first time I've ever looked forward to women playing over men. And I've been consistent with you all saying that, and it's going to be a great game. And you really hadn't seen nothing yet. After LSU take care of business tonight and bet that on Beth Saracen, might I add.
Like it?
They're going to beat South Carolina.
Ooh.
LSU is going to win everything, guys.
You think they're going back?
Third time's a charm for LSU, huh?
Yeah, I really do believe that. I'm
convinced more than ever that I heard you last night. You've got a twin out there that's got the same voice, the speech pattern, the tone, the inflection.
What show was it?
It was just whatever's here on 103.7 The Buzz, late night, ESPN. I was driving in from Shreveport listening, and I was like, dude. And I'm like, I know this voice. I know this guy. And I kept listening. I was like, that is 49er John. And then at the end, I missed the very beginning when they said, you know, the guy's name. And I just caught the call about halfway through. And I was like, man, that is 49er John. And then at the end, they go, all right, DJ, that was a great call. Thanks, DJ. And I was like, well, maybe he used a different name when he called in.
No, I've never perpetrated who I am. I'm always 49er John. And it's only two shows that I call into, this show and this show in San Francisco.
All right.
So,
I was wrong.
Either one of those shows.
I would have lost some money. I was playing.
Well, I'm sorry. I had hit a 17 parlay yesterday, and then I ended up playing dominoes last night. So
that was
I wasn't
a good
on
day.
The radio. Oh yeah, I had a hell of a day. and guys, I'm telling you all, LSU tonight.
All right.
Hammer play.
All right.
Hammer play.
I will. I'll do it. Just because of you. And that way, if I lose,
I'm
blaming you. All right.
Blame me. It won't be close.
All right. Joe's on his phone right now. He may be making the bet right now.
Yeah,
but please put it in. I mean, put $300-$500 on it. You know?
Why not?
Especially if you big time. You can do that.
I don't bet like that.
Well, this is a hammer play.
All right.
Well, put everything you have on it.
All right.
You say everything.
Everything.
Hammer play. Yeah.
It's only
and then
1.5.
Hey, what is the odds?
Iowa.
What is the odds for UConn being the favorite in the Final Four?
It's not out yet.
For the men?
Yeah, the men.
To win the title now?
Yeah, you know how like one team may be 3-1 or
I saw that earlier today.
Yeah, since the Final Four is set, maybe it should be out.
Yeah, it should be on Sirius, and we'll have to look through it for it. Top of the hour break's coming up, 49er John. I'll look during the break. Thanks, man.
Hey, man, I appreciate y'all.
See ya. Thanks for the tip. Well, thanks now. We'll see if it comes through tomorrow. Guess I should wait and hold off on the thanks until the game is over.
Okay, UConn is -190, according to Bet Saracen.
To win the title or win the next game?
To win the title. -190. Purdue is +195. Alabama +1,500. And NC State +1,750.
I saw yesterday, before the tournament started, North Carolina State was like +24,000 to win it all.
Yeah. Of course, when you get to this point, then the odds are going to go down.
Well, I mean, who would have thought, you know, they'd have won four straight and get where they are. I mean, they've been a big underdog. I know the last three games.
Here are your odds for MOP. And, of course, these teams need to win a game to advance to have a chance in the championship game. But Zach Edey is +200. Donovan Klingon is +220. Tristan Newton is +550.
A little flyer there on Newton?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it goes a little bit deeper than that.
Sure.
This is the top three.
Like Burns would be, you know, some really big odds to be the MVP or MOP. Of the tournament, but they would have to win one more game to get there and then probably have to win the game to be the MOP.
Oh, no doubt. Yeah, you have to win the game.
I mean, it would have to be something special, like an Edey game last night where you score 40 but lose a close game.
Yeah.
And even then, I don't know, you'd still get it.
So then it's Cam Spencer at 700, Stephen Castle at +2,000, Braden Smith +2,250, Mark Sears +2,500, and then DJ Burns +3,000.
Wow. All right, coming up in the next hour, we'll talk more about the NCAA tournament when Joe Klein joins us. We'll take some more phone calls. I see the phone ringing. Yeah, we'll open it up. We got a full hour without any guests, just hanging out with Joe, talking basketball and Razorback baseball. Of course, I want to talk some more about that. Man, the pitching is just dirty for Arkansas. They added Dietz, got an inning in, or almost an inning yesterday. Stick around.
At Eat My Catfish, we've got fresh live crawfish, and all you have to do is just add the fixins. Be sure to come see us or order online at eatmycatfish.com. Eat local, eat fresh, eat my catfish.
This is a test of the emergency alert system. This is only a test.
We're with Bridget, whose husband won't be home for months, and whose daughter is due any day. We're with Mike, who's leaving home to protect his family and yours. We're with all service members and their families who need community, connection, and maybe a bit of magic. Are you with them? Learn more at USO.org today.
You can hear the best of the NCAA tournament on 106.7 Buzz 2, from the very beginning all the way to the championship game. March Madness on 103.7 The Buzz and 106.7 Buzz 2.
Make this summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch is all about creating fun on our lakes and rivers. You have to come by and see the new 2024 G3 Tritunes, the hottest and coolest ride out there. We're easy to find. Take the Levy exit.
The Great American.
Do you smell that? That's the smell of men being men.
I think I'm ready.
On 103.7 The Buzz, KABC Little Rock.
Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
A Little Rock student has a big decision to make after being accepted to 16 universities, including four Ivy League schools. Nora Ali is a senior at Pulaski Academy in Little Rock and president of the student council. She's been accepted to 16 different schools like Harvard, Columbia, Cornell, NYU, Rice, UCLA. The list goes on and on. On top of receiving a full ride to UMKC Medical School. Congratulations to Nora. The University of Central Arkansas is collaborating with the Arkansas Department of Education to collect data during the upcoming solar eclipse. UCA designed 250 circuit boards that they'll distribute to 60 schools in 45 Arkansas counties. They'll measure light, speed, temperature, and even sounds during that event. UCA will use the data for future projects and student research. And don't forget to tune in to Channel 7 News live coverage of the eclipse on Monday, April 8th. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Oaklawn Racing Casino Resort presents Oaklawn Race Day with Justin Akery and David Wanginati every Saturday morning at 11. Oaklawn Race Day is your inside track to America's hottest thoroughbred action and Arkansas source for racing news and analysis. Oaklawn Race Day, presented by Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Cloudy to mostly cloudy skies today. Rather warm with a high around 79 and windy too. Tonight we've got some rain and thunderstorms moving across the state. Those could be strong to severe, especially across northwestern Arkansas. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Tune in every Friday morning to hear Danny West from HogSports.com on Morning Mayhem. Brought to you by HJ Trailer Sales. They've got truck beds and utility trailers for every type of job and a service facility for maintenance and repair. Local folks with great products. Visit them online at HJTrailerSales.com or in person at 808 Albert Pike in Hot Springs.
Clint Sterner here. Guys, if you've noticed a lack of energy, motivation, and drive, it could be low T. Be sure to schedule your health assessment at Low T Center. For established patients, they offer the convenience of physician-monitored self-inject at-home testosterone treatments with an average payment of $150 a month cash pay, including labs and medication. If you need the convenience of at-home treatment, Low T Center makes it easy, shipping treatments directly to your house. Go to lowtcenter.com now to book your appointment online. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Cobra Commander, I figured out when to attack G.I. Joe.
What's your new idea, Destro?
We attack Saturday at 9 a.m. They'll all be listening to Gwatney Unplugged at 103.7 The Buzz.
Excellent.
This is Pat Bradley for Brewskies. Everybody thinks about Brewskies for watching sports or having a great night out. But what about Brewskies for lunch? Both locations open at 11 a.m. 7 days a week with all your pub grub favorites, friendly service, kitchen all-stars are ready to serve you. Or, if you're not in a hurry, have a couple cold ones. Happy hour starts at 11 a.m. too. Brewskies, you're home for lunch, happy hour, and late night now with two locations, downtown Little Rock and the brand new location in Lakewood Village, North Little Rock.
Are you someone who tries to drive while distracted by your phone? Someone who props it on the steering wheel or peeks down at it for a glance or just scrolls and scrolls? If so, you could be the next person to get into a fender bender, get a ticket, veer off the road, or even cause a crash that kills you or someone else. Enough already. Put the phone away or pay. Paid for by NHTSA.
Small business owners, we know finishing your to-do list can feel like climbing a mountain, but that mountain is also covered in banana peels. Then, when something new gets added to your list, you're like, nope, I'm already climbing this huge, super slippery banana peel mountain of a to-do list. At Progressive, we don't want to make your day any harder. That's why we make it easy to manage your policy on our mobile app. So climbing that banana peel mountain feels more like a leisurely stroll. See if you can save on commercial auto insurance in as little as 6 minutes at ProgressiveCommercial.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Coverage subject to policy terms and conditions.
For Pulaski County residents and businesses, do recycling right by recycling old electronic equipment. How? Come to North Little Rock Simmons Bank Arena parking lot on Tuesday, April 2nd or Wednesday, April 3rd for an electronic recycling event. Learn more at recyclingunplugged.com. If it's electronic and no longer usable, drop it off and we'll recycle it for free. For information, go to recyclingunplugged.com.
If you're driving a car or truck with an expired warranty and suddenly lost your transmission or needed a full engine repair, would a $4,000 repair bill leave you stranded? I'm Danica Patrick. Don't get caught off guard with a vehicle breakdown. Choose the company I trust, Endurance. No matter the mileage, if your vehicle is less than 20 years old, Endurance offers auto protection plans for any budget. Protection on the drivetrain, electrical, transmission, AC, and more. Plus 24/7 roadside assistance and rental car reimbursement on any plan. Endurance handles everything from making the claim to paying the mechanic of your choice. Act now and get one full year of elite benefits, a $2,000 value, free.
Endurance has paid hundreds of millions in claims. Call for your fast free quote today. Call 800-686-8079. That's 800-686-8079.
Live from the Signal Media Studios, this is Out of Bounds with Joe Franklin and Wes Moore on 103.7 The Buzz. Where my accountant lives, in fact, I'm down in this. You say with my boo babe, tastes like Kool-Aid for the analyst. Girl, I can buy a Westie world with my base stuff. I know that it's good, won't you sit it on my taste buds? I get way too petty, won't you let me do the extras? Pull up on your block and break it down, we playing Tetris. AM to the PM, PM to the AM funk. Eat up your per diem, you just gotta hate them funk. If I quit your BM, I still rock Mercedes funk. If I quit this season, I still be the greatest.
Too little, too late for Clemson, though, on the run out. Estrada, and he will lay it in. And the Alabama Crimson Tide will roll into the Final Four for the first time in program history.
I mean, I'm going to be honest. The last time they picked us the fifth best team in the SEC, we won the whole thing. So my plan was to win the whole thing. But didn't happen. We lost the game against Tennessee at home, which thought we had a chance to win that. If we'd have won that, we'd have won the SEC again. But they weren't far off because we finished tied for fifth, tied for second, tied for fifth. It was all, there was a four-way tie there. So we ended up with the three seed. But, you know, for a team picked fifth, and really we haven't been healthy for a while. Like, the last time we were fully healthy, we beat Texas A&M, who's a really good team. They almost beat Houston. You know, when Houston was healthy, you know, we beat them by 25. So this has turned out to be a pretty good team when we were healthy. For us to win these two games, to go to a Final Four without Reitzel, who was playing unbelievably well, as good as any guard we have, shows a lot about the character of this team. And Reitzel was as good of an assistant coach as – so we had on the bench these last two games. He's been great. But, you know, this team's come a long way. the program, the staff. I got three brand new assistants. You know, I'm happy for the three assistants that left that helped lay this foundation, for other people that have moved on that laid the foundation. To be honest with you, some previous coaches, I mean, we walked into a pretty good talent pool. You know, Avery did a pretty good job getting talent here, and we were able to win in our second year with the talent that he had brought in, Herb, Petty, Reese. So you don't want to ignore the fact that a pretty good foundation, Greg Byrne knows what he's doing, gives us everything we need to succeed, and here we are. And, you know, school's first ever Final Four. When I got the job, I thought, you know, before I ever took the job, you know, Rick, my agent, and me talked, and he said, look, they've got all the resources you need to be able to win at Alabama. We need to go get this job. So I trust him. He knows what he's doing. They do have all the resources you need to win, and we put together a few good teams. You just got to keep knocking on the door. We were, you know, last year, number one overall seed, we should have been in the Final Four, but it doesn't work that way. Like, the best team doesn't always win because it's a one-game elimination tournament. You got to be hot at the right time, and we looked like we were not hot at the right time, losing, what did they lose, four of our last six or something going into this tournament. But our staff was good. We looked at some other teams that were similar to this. Syracuse did it twice. I called Jim Boeheim on that Sunday, like, you know, what do we got to do? You know, I talked to him, maybe it was that Saturday. I called Frank Martin. South Carolina made a Final Four run when they weren't hot at the end of the year. You know, I asked him what he did. I tried to pick the brain. I called Coach Saban. You know, what do we got to do? And he kind of gave me the next idea, next. So guys bought in. We can make this run. Other teams have done it. We've got the capability to do it. We got to get back to playing great defense, or get to start to playing great defense. I don't know if back's the correct word. But, you know, we can have the number one offense in the country. We had it for a majority of the year. Let's put a top 20 defense together with them. We can make a Final Four, and I think we've done that.
And they've done it. Alabama will take on UConn. They are an 11.5-point favorite. I like Alabama. I like what they're doing, but not in this game. No, I like UConn, and I think UConn covers the 11.5. That's how much I think of UConn. Joe Klein is with us. How are you, Joe?
Good, good. Doing good, man. Had a good weekend and went well.
I teased this earlier in the show. You have to be excited to see North Carolina State, Purdue, the way they use their – and even UConn, the way they'll throw it into the post. This is got to be refreshing for you.
Well, it is. I mean, I think it's badly needed brand of basketball that needs to be seen to maybe hopefully reboot. Again, it's never going to be like it was because the analytics won't allow that. And plus, it's too hard to find and develop guys like an ED. And, I mean, you can find a lot more 6'2 shooters than you can 7'3 dominant post players. So, I mean,
there's only one of those right now.
But, I mean, I think it shows that, I mean, it can really put a strain on a defense. And, I mean, you can still play that way and win. You can, again, you don't want to slow it down, but you play through your best player. Mm-hmm. And I don't think Purdue slows it down at all. I think they, you know, the biggest overrated analytical stat out there is tempo. I mean, tempo is, oh, we play fast. Are you efficient?
Mm-hmm.
Efficiency, you know, your offensive efficiency is way more. You don't see a lot of teams that make it deep run that are tempo teams. They're efficient.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they run their stuff and they're efficient offensively, they're efficient defensively, but this whole, you know, they play fast thing is, you know, whoop-de-doo. I mean, you know, we drive really fast. We have a car wreck, but we go fast.
That seems to be the question on Edie. Edie, he's able to play a lot of minutes on the college level, but the question is always, looking at him as an NBA prospect, would he be able to play a certain number of minutes? Yeah. And anytime you hear analysts talking about him, they're talking about him and being in situations of playing limited minutes.
Right. Well, you got to use him. You know, if you're gonna play him, you got to use. I mean, could he be effective in the NBA? Absolutely, because he's going to be posting up a 6'8", dude. I mean, he's not playing against Shaq. He's not playing against Olajuwon. You know, those guys aren't out there. So can he be effective? Yeah. Now, is he going to have to learn how to do some things defensively? The first thing they're going to do with him is throw him in a pick and roll. I mean, and get a guy popping or rolling, or can he stay in front of people? Can he do things effectively in a pick and roll? But, again, you know, he can be a big problem at the other end. I mean, you know, you start switching like they do in the NBA. They switch everything. You start switching the pick and roll on him, and he rolls down there. You just throw it up there, and he's gonna be able to finish for you. So, I think he could be effective, but you got to use him. If you just put him out there and, you know, not run stuff for him and not let him be effective and not take advantage of the things that he can do, then
it'd be the wrong fit for him.
Yeah, you just coach him, you know, and that's a thing. There ain't a lot of that that goes on these days. There's some good coach, but I mean, it's like Illinois, we're going to do what we do. Remember hearing him say that? We're going to keep driving it in there on UConn. We're going to do what we do. And you saw what that got him, you know, 30 to nothing later. I mean, you know, that was the most bizarre stuff. I mean, they didn't double team that big guy. They were just going to run up and down and play and attack the rim, and ain't happening, man.
30 points later.
Well, I mean, you got to make that guy guard somebody that can shoot. If you're a small team, you know, you can't let him sit back there and hang out. And that's what he was doing. He was just hanging out in the paint.
Let's look ahead to the North Carolina State-Purdue matchup, because you got DJ Burns, big guy with a lot of weight that can maybe push on Edie a little bit. He's going to give up some height because he's probably, as what I've read, only 6'7", not really 6'9", but that's probably about 5-8 inches that he's giving up. Can he be effective in keeping Edie out of his position?
I think it depends on how Edie plays him. I think what Edie's got to do is fight him in the post, and then he's got to get off him, because Burns' footwork is incredible, and he'll spin on you, he'll take you one way, he'll get an angle on you, so he'll negate the size advantage because he's going to get around you. What Edie's got to do is fight him, and then when he gets it, he's got to get off. And then when he starts, you know, he's got to be able to move and just stay between him and the basket. I mean, if he just get big, wall him up, he can't shoot over you. He can't. So you got to try to stay in front of him. Now, again, that's easier said than done because he's got great footwork. I mean, so he'll take you one way and come back the other and do a lot of that. But, you know, if he gets to banging with that big guy when he's got the ball and pressing up against him, Burns going to spin off him and get to the hole, get to the other side of the rim, do all that, you know, crafty stuff that he's so good at. So I think he can be effective, but I also think that if Edie could give him a lot of problems if he moves his feet and just doesn't try to stop him, just make him try to make shots over him. Because I don't think Burns will try to do that. I think he'll pass it out because he's a very willing passer. He likes to pass, but I think Edie's got a big advantage there.
Yeah.
So you think both players on the offensive end, that's where their advantage is for Edie and Burns?
Yeah, I mean, I think what we'd all like to see is, I can't remember the big kid's name. Is it Klingon with Kling? What's the
Klingon? Yeah, Donovan Klingon.
I think we would all kind of want to see what he could do with Edie, match it up. But to be quite honest with you, I don't think there's anybody in this tournament that one-on-one in the post can guard Edie, because he's so big and wide. He holds his position well. He can go over either shoulder, and they look for him. You know, their whole, you know, if you front him, they're looking to reverse the ball to where he can pin you, or flashing a high guy to get the high low. So they're, you know, he's not just down there posting up. He's posting up and they're reading how they're playing them, reading where they're coming from, and they're adjusting. So, I think if any of the remaining teams just try to play him single coverage, I mean, I think he can get 30 on anybody.
Well, I thought Purdue did a great job against Tennessee using him in the pick and roll, and it wasn't so much as the pick, and they were popping and shooting off of it. And he really wasn't rolling. When he was rolling, he wasn't looking for the ball. He was just rolling down to the front of the rim to get position. Great position. Yeah. And then the help side defender who would come over was so small, he had zero chance whatsoever.
Absolutely.
And what I'm thinking with North Carolina State, they're doing that. Maybe that's when they can get the other big guy, whether it's Klingon or somebody, to come over and that be the help defender. And so at least you have somebody with some size that can try to stop that.
And, Wes, I think you got it. I mean, if you look at what Purdue did, they kept doing the same thing over and over. I mean, you got to throw a zone in there. You got to trap the ball screen one time. You know, you just can't let them run this stuff. You know, pick and roll. He rolls down. You know, Bazzini high post, pick and roll, rolls down there, gets position. Now we swing it around and we throw it into him.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, every now and then you got to – hit him with a zone, you know, two or three possessions. When he comes off the ball screen, blitz it one time, you know, go under one time. I mean, but if you just give them – they're so good at playing through him that if you just give them a vanilla look like, you know, I think Tennessee did. You know, Tennessee kind of was like, hey, we got three big guys. We're going to try to beat him up and wear him down. I think, you know, I don't know what Illinois – was trying to do. I mean, they were a smaller team, but they were trying to guard him with a 6'7" dude. I mean, good luck with that. And so, you know, I just think you got to show multiple looks at them and try to get them, you know, off kilter a little bit and try to get them to play from behind, maybe, and get them to hurry up a little bit more. But again, if you just show the same look and let them pick and roll him down into the post and set up camp, I mean, you're gonna put a 30 burger on you at least.
Yeah, as a result of that, Joe, he got a career high and got 40 in this game. Yeah.
It was almost like, all right, he can get his, but nobody else is going to score, and that's how we're going to win this game.
Well.
And they scored enough. His teammates scored enough, just enough, to beat Tennessee.
Yeah, I mean – you don't want to give up 40 to anybody, because when you give up 40 to somebody, you're saying, okay, if the other seven guys that play score 5 points each, we got 75 points. Mm. I love Rick Barnes. I think he's great, and you know you got to have supreme confidence in him. And this is what he does. He doesn't play zone and do things like that. And I get it, but I just think against teams like that, they're one dimensional. I mean, really, if you think about it, I mean, they're not totally one. I mean, they have other good players, but I mean, what they're trying to do is what they're trying to do. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're very, very geared and you know, this is now Tennessee was wanting to get Connect involved, but they do it in a various different ways. I mean, the transition, curling him off the down screens or popping him or getting him into pick and roll. But, you know, with Edie, they're trying to get him to set up camp in the lane and go to work. So I think you got to show really good teams with really good, their guards are smart. Their team is smart. You can't let them know what's coming every time. You gotta change it up a little bit.
For UConn being as dominant as they are, have Bama next. And then the winner of NC State, Purdue, of those three teams, which one would you give the best chance, like, as far as the matchup?
I think Purdue, because I think Purdue has got a dude that UConn can't guard one-on-one, in my opinion. I think they have a guy that can – it's better than anybody else in the big kid clinging, but, I mean, they're going to have to send help or something. I mean, and I think once you start doing that, you know, the whole essence of any offense that you try to run is you're trying to get either off a dribble penetration, off a post-up, off a transition. You're trying to get two guys to guard one guy so that now you can play off of that and get numbers and get advantages in other areas. And so I think you know, if UConn plays him straight up, I think he can really present a problem. And then, you know, how do they do that? Does them having to give a little more attention to Edie, you know, help free up other guys? But, you know, saying all this, Purdue's got to guard them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, you know, we get kind of caught up in how they're going to guard Purdue, how they're going to – well, how's Purdue going to guard them? That's kind of – you get kind of, you know, all – you know, I don't know if they can guard – well, they may not have to, you know, because they might be turning you over and doing things to you defensively that take him out of the game.
Well, the games that Purdue have lost this year, they pointed that out during the Tennessee game. It was because of turnovers.
Absolutely.
In Tennessee, when they made their run a couple of times, they were turning Purdue over.
Got it going up and down.
Yeah, and at the end of the game, they couldn't get any turnovers.
Yeah, you can't – if you get caught in that, you know, 65 to 75 kind of
– the grind.
Plodding around up and down half-court game, which is what Purdue wants, then they're going to have a shot.
Alabama is an 11.5-point underdog. What do they have to do to pull off that upset?
Alabama's got to get that bad boy going up and down. They're a Lamborghini.
Mm-hmm.
And they need to get
just go full
thing.
Throttle on
yeah,
them.
They got to get that thing just at a havoc pace and going up and down, and then hopefully get UConn playing fast enough to where they a little faster than they're comfortable playing and get some turnovers and get some things in the half court. Now, again, you know, how's Alabama going to guard them? I mean, that's what we always, you know, we're like, you know, I mean, Alabama's got to show up a little bit defensively. They got to rebound the ball. They're going to have to somehow get some turnovers and get some things so they can get in the open floor, which, again, against UConn is much easier said than done.
Grant Nelson had one of those type games where he laid it all out, did everything he needed to do for Bama to come through with a win. And he really hasn't been that all season.
No.
He's kind of been up and down, but now you're starting to see flashes of it.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, technically they could play small, put him at the five when the big kid's in there, and – tell him to come get him. You know, come get Nelson. You know, I mean, we're gonna have him out here and picking rolls and popping and try to pull the big kid out away from the paint a little bit and see if he can play out on the floor. Now again, you go to the other end and you got big problems down there. And so, but yeah, he's got to be good. The freshman kid. The 6'8 kid that can shoot it, he's a freshman. I can't think of his name, but they're guys with their size. The Stevenson kid that's a freshman also from Chapel Hill. I mean, they're big guys that, you know. I think Pringle is really the only guy that really doesn't stretch the floor for them from a big standpoint. So I think it's going to be huge for their bigs to be able to knock down shots. I think offensively, because if they can, again, get the spacing and get guys away from the floor, you know, I mean, Alabama can go nuts. I mean, offensively, they can hit 100 on you, you know. And so if they get it going, if UConn gets to where they want to play a, you know, where UConn's got to get this ego thing, Joe, where you're kind of like, we can play with them, we can go at their pace, and you know that. You know, you got to stay away from that with Alabama because they're better at it than you are.
Right.
That's what they do. Now you can get 85 on them, but you start going up and down.
Now you're playing their game.
They can put 105 on you. So you want to be careful in the fact that you want to take advantage of them when you can, but you don't want to just start jacking threes and run up and down the floor because you're not that's going to play right into their hands.
Let's take a call real quick. Sean's in Little Rock. Sean, welcome to Out of Bounds.
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Good.
All right. I just wanted to see, because I remember at the beginning of the year when Arkansas beat Purdue, the coach said he thanked Arkansas for the crowd and for the game because it was getting his team ready. And I just wonder why nobody's used the same formula that Arkansas used to beat them. And what was that formula? That's what Joe Klein. What formula did the Razorbacks use to beat Purdue, and why is no one else using the formula?
I gave the same question to somebody a few weeks back, and they had a thing called the ED rules. And they basically devoted two guys to Edie the whole time, or even on box outs. They had two guys go to him on box outs. If your man was on the other side of the floor, you had to be in the restricted area, not in the paint. If he was posting up on one side of the floor, you had to be almost at least underneath the basket, or even more so towards him. So they basically had rules specifically for Edie on guarding him before he caught the ball, and then they tried to get two guys to him on box outs for to keep him off the glass.
Yeah, well, thank you. That's what I wanted to know, and that's why I love Musselman, because what he has going the way he wants to, he can scheme anybody out of a game. I'm going to hang up and listen. Thank you.
Thanks, John. He's got a little bit of Belichick in him. He doesn't want you to win the way you want to win.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, and I think that was what was so frustrating to him this year, is he didn't have the defensive team that could consistently take people out of what they wanted to do.
Can't wait. Be a fun Saturday. Another great Saturday coming up. Plenty of basketball. Some good games tonight, too. Some women's back. You've been watching any of the women?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Tonight's going to be fun.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to tonight. That's going to be – I always like a little hate, Wes.
Well, I was listening.
They say they don't hate each other and all that, but there's a strong dislike there, and I always like that. I like that when I played. I like that when I coached. Just gives it a little spice.
Yeah. A little intensity.
Yep.
Notches it up a little bit.
Yep.
More with Joe Klein when we come back. Stick around. It's Out of Bounds.
Coach Kevin Kelly joins The Zone each Wednesday, presented by the Wittrock Athletic Club.
This is a test of the emergency alert system. This is only a test. This is SportsCenter.
The Final Four of the men's college basketball is set and will be played on Saturday. Purdue will take on NC State in Game 1 at 5:09. NC State is back in the Final Four for the first time since winning the national championship in 1983, while Purdue is making it for the first time since 1980. UConn and Alabama will face off in Game 2 at 7:49. It's the Tide's first ever Final Four appearance. The Huskies are currently favored by over 10 points. Both games will be on CBS. And in the Elite Eight of the women's tournament, Iowa will take on LSU in the national championship rematch tonight at 6 on ESPN, and then following that game, UConn and USC will face off at 8. NC State and South Carolina already punched their tickets to the Final Four. They'll face each other on Friday. I'm Christian Weaver with the Buzz Radio Network. Nancy Holtis, host of Oakwan Today, joins Justin and DJ in The Zone each week, presented by the Gangster Museum of America and the Hattery of Hot Springs, where you won't be gambling on a good time, but betting on a sure thing. Visit TGMOA.com and come see us at 510 Central Avenue in downtown Hot Springs.
Fellas, if you've been feeling tired and grumpy, noticed a lack of motivation and drive, you may have low T. Low testosterone levels can cause weight gain, loss of muscle mass, and so much more. I recommend Low T Center. That's where I got my levels tested. They make it quick, it's easy to get your levels checked, and it's only $25. And with their on-site lab, you'll get results back in about 25 minutes. Most insurance is accepted for treatment. Go to lowtcenter.com now to book your appointment online. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Tackle your outdoor projects with Greenway Equipment's Lawn Patrol Package. Handling is effortless with the John Deere 1023E's twin touch foot controls with a hydrostatic transmission and four wheel drive with power steering. The 60D drive over auto connect belly mower makes mowing easy, and the 120R quick park loader is perfect for dirt moving and mulching projects. With 0% APR for 84 months,
months and a 6-year powertrain warranty, it's a deal you can't miss. For more information, head to your local Greenway or visit gogreenway.com. With approved credit, see dealer for details.
Make this summer one to remember by stopping by Arch Marine in North Little Rock. Arch is all about creating fun on our lakes and rivers. You have to come by and see the new 2024 G3 Tritunes, the hottest and coolest ride out there. We're easy to find. Take the Levy exit.
Hello, folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
Join The Zone broadcasting live Tuesday from the VIP lot at Simmons Bank Arena for the Regional Recycling's Electronic Recycling Event. Drop off your old electronics for free between 7 a.m. and 2 p.m. Tuesday and Wednesday. For more information, go to recyclingunplugged.com.
Are you someone who tries to drive while distracted by your phone? Someone who props it up on the steering wheel or peeks down at it for a glance? Or just scrolls and scrolls? If so, you could be the next person to get into a fender bender, get a ticket, veer off the road, or even cause a crash that kills you or someone else. Enough with the phones already. Put them down and pay attention, or pay the price. You drive, you text, you pay. Paid for by NHTSA.
Out of Bounds with Joe Franklin and Wes Moore on 103.7 The Buzz.
This is number one champion sound. Yeah, Estelle, we about to get down. Who the hottest in the world right now? Just touched down in London town. Bet they give me a pound. Tell them put the money in my hand right now. Got a promoter, we need more seats. We just sold out all the floor seats.
Take me on a trip, I'd like to go someday. Take me to New York, I'd like.
Weekend Recap brought to you by Fleet Management Services, serving Central Arkansas for over 20 years. They're your small to mid-sized specialist. When you need someone to service your fleet and get your employees back on the road quick, call 501-375-3672.
Wes Moore, Joe Franklin, it is Out of Bounds. We got Joe Klein from Corky's hanging out with us on the Southern Structural Solutions text line. Randall says, what's the deal? Seinfeld, what's the deal? With all the Thursday, Friday, Saturday series, I miss watching the Hogs on Sunday afternoons. Yeah, me too. The first weekend against Auburn, that was a TV deal where they played Thursday, Friday, Saturday. TV picked them up. This past weekend, Arkansas traditionally is off for Easter. I think that's something Coach Van Horn requests, and that's why they traditionally play Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Easter weekend. This weekend, once again, we have a TV game on Thursday, so I think that's why, because of Ole Miss this weekend, TV selected Arkansas for the Thursday night game, so they play Thursday, Friday, Saturday. The following weekend, it goes back, to a Friday, Saturday, Sunday. I like it. I like it when we have a Thursday night game. I'm all excited. We got Thursday and Friday game, but then come Sunday, I'm like you. I'm like, man, I wish they were playing today. Wish I had some baseball to watch.
There was a lot more of them this time of the year, this part of the schedule. And they put them all back to back, so that's why it feels a lot different.
Yeah, now I loved it though. I was watching baseball and going back to basketball, back and forth. I mean, it was perfect.
Saturday, I had the baseball game at Oaklawn at the Tito's tent, watching the game, watching the races, and I was in heaven, man. It was fantastic.
Tito's tent.
Yep.
Basketball, Arkansas baseball. Yeah, you were going good.
Man. I was. Life was good. Except for Joe. I told Acre, and I told everybody here, I had to limit myself. I drank a lot of water because I left the races and drove to Shreveport to be there with Allison and her family and my daughter for Easter. So I was a responsible adult and had to drink a lot of water minus the Tito's.
That Allison's got to understand.
I had plenty of people offer and say, hey, you can just stay here. You can stay with us. You can stay at the lake house, whatever. You don't have to drive.
I think I'd have just gone to Shreveport. If I had to go to the Tito's tent and not partake, I think I'd just be like, you know what, guys, I'm going to Shreveport.
That's how much I like the races, though. I mean, I love watching the races and being there. And then Derby Day.
People
I didn't
want
to miss that. That's my deal.
Yeah.
This one from Darren in Russellville. DJ Burns has a big old body and soft touch. Kind of like and then he's got the cordless footwork. Can't wait to see him versus Edie. It was Big O versus Shaq. It has that Big O versus Shaq feel to it. I love seeing college basketball get back to playing with the back to the basketball and playing bully ball in the paint. Did you write that in? Was that you?
No, I hadn't.
That was Darren in Russellville.
I totally agree. I just like it because it's different. I get in coaching. I just can't tell you the number of scouting reports that I would do, and it's just everybody, you know, pick and roll. It was, you know, it got to where you were like, last week they called this 44, this week it's 22. You mm-hmm. know, it was like same stuff, different day. And so it's nice to see somebody, you know, playing to their strength. I get why people play that way because, again, you know, everybody goes, why can't Arkansas play that way? Well, you know, Zach Edey's and those type of guys are harder to find. Mm-hmm. And then if you remember, his first 2 years, solid player. But credit to him, I mean, he's just kept getting better and getting better and getting better, and now he's a dominant force.
Yeah, he was almost impossible to stop at times. And it was just all because
you can't guard him one-on-one.
Right.
He's so big, but the offense they run. I mean, if you front him, they're looking to reverse the ball. He'll pin you. They'll throw it over. I mean, so it's a combination of not that. I mean, again, he's great, but they are looking for him. So if you play behind him or however you know, they are crafting ball reversal and things to get him the ball. And again, he's very good at pinning, holding his position. And then when he catches it, I mean, he's just where he is catching it, he's just too big. I mean, he's too big, man.
Kit and The Rock says it was good to hear from Coach Barry Odom. I think he is as good as a defensive coach as there is if he has the talent at the positions to play his scheme. He sounds like a coach that players would want to play for. I agree. That was a fun call. We had Barry Odom on earlier today talking about his experiences at UNLV and riding a bull. He rode a bull, and it raised money for his football
raised
program.
Raised money for his medical bills.
Have you seen the video?
I have not.
Okay, do yourself a favor and Google it and watch it.
Was he in a foam suit?
No, but he did have a helmet on, you know. But it only lasts like 2 seconds, if 2 seconds. It was $1 and gone. Mm. And he took a nice little hit. I'm looking forward to the Battle of the Bigs. This is from the 501. 7'4", 300 pounds versus 6'9", 290. Edie and Burns Jr. in the Purdue-North Carolina State game. Yeah, I think a lot of people are excited about that matchup. I don't know how – I thought Edie was even bigger than that.
He's big, man. He's.
What's he listed at? Is it 300? He's just listed 300? Yeah. I thought it was bigger.
Yeah, no, easily over
easy
300.
Easy 300. He's easy. I mean, I would say at least 7'3".
Mm-hmm. Some NFL scouts were talking about Burns, and they said they don't think he's 6'9". He's probably around 6'7". But the footwork, they said, man, this guy could be a left tackle or right tackle. Yeah. You know, with that footwork, that size.
Yep.
They want him to work out. They want to put him through some drills season.
I mean, I think he would be – I mean – developing. There was a kid who played for Western Kentucky. We played against him years ago, a Little Rock named Fant. And he was 6'6", 260, solid, great footwork, just a load on the post. And he ended up playing left tackle for Seattle Seahawks for a few years.
Huh.
I was sitting at home one night and watching the watching a football game, and they kept saying, I was like, and they Fant out of Western Kentucky, and I was, you know, so I Googled him, and
sure enough, it's him.
It was him.
Wow. Let's take some phone calls. Duffer's in Cabot. Duffer, welcome into Out of Bounds.
Hey, good afternoon, gentlemen.
What's up?
Hey. Joe, Tiki was telling everybody, Joe, that you would dominate Zach Edey, and I believe it. You're quicker than him, more smart than him, you'd dominate him.
Well,
I will tell you one other thing, too, though, and this is the absolute truth. UConn, NC State, or Alabama will not beat Duke. Zach Edey only gets one foul and gets to put up a campfire in the lane all day long.
Well, they're not calling the lane.
No, they're not. There were a couple times.
Those days are done. Yeah. So, again, that's another thing that works to his favor. I mean, he gets position, and then if you front him, he just stays there until you reverse the ball, and then they throw it to him. So, yeah, I mean, the way they call the game – it's very beneficial for Edey.
There was one time he did the pick and roll, rolled through the lane, stayed in the lane. They reversed it. He went to the other side, never got out of the lane. I'm like, that had to be like six. We were at a restaurant, so I couldn't rewind it. I was like, that had to be like 6 or 7 seconds he was in the paint.
I counted several times that were 8 to 10. Just, you know, and I mean, you're nitpicking. I mean, he had 1 foot in the lane, which, you know, but again, back in the day, you know, I mean, you'd look down there, they'd call you for 3 seconds, you'd look down there and your foot would be on the line. It'd be like, come on, man, you know, are you kidding me?
Shaq has a great commercial right now referencing something like that. Going in and out. And he's staying out of the lane.
Those commercials. And then he's cleaning the backboard real gently.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
How did he only draw one foul?
They were letting him play, I'll tell you that, Duffer. They were banging around. They were banging him.
They got a great whistle. I mean, they shot 33 free throws. I think Tennessee shot 11. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you know, I mean, they were going inside, though. I mean, they were throwing it to him, and Tennessee was playing a lot on the perimeter. So, I mean, that normally happens. But, again, that's if that happens, whomever they play, that's going to be a
tough
problem.
Yep. Duffer, thanks. Let's go to Stan. Stan, we're up against it. What's up?
Hey, what's up? What's up? Joe, Big Joe.
Stan. What's up, Stan?
Big Joe.
Yes,
Big Joe.
Yeah, man.
Joe, I ate the fish. I ate that good fish here yesterday at your place up there, man.
I caught it just for you. I was out there fishing all weekend to catch that for you on Sunday, bro.
Yeah, I'm coming to your buffet, man, Monday, man.
Come on. Come on.
Hey, look here. Hey, I tell you what, if North Carolina State can't stop Eddie, if North Carolina State can't stop him, I guarantee you, UConn will take care of you. They'll take care of his big, tall ass.
Thank you, Sam.
Well, the whole key is you got to make him play at the other end. You got to get it going up and down a little bit. You can't go nuts, but you get plodding around in the mud like they want to do, and you're asking for it.
We'll finish up when we come back. It's Out of Bounds. Joe Franklin, Wes Moore, and Joe Klein hanging out. Stick around.
The numbers are in. And once again, Channel 7's Barry Brandt is Arkansas's most watched meteorologist, with more than twice the viewers of anyone else. And the reason is simple. 36 years of consistently accurate forecasts and dependability in severe weather. A reputation built on experience. Chief Meteorologist Barry Brandt, Arkansas's most watched, most experienced, and most trusted. Weeknights on Channel 7 News at 6 and 10.
This is the Pigskin Preacher, bringing you the word. The psalmist writes, "The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hands. Day after day they pour forth speech. Night after night they reveal knowledge. There is no speech or language where their voice is not heard." You'll see this for yourself on April the 8th, 2024, as Arkansas is right in the path to see the solar eclipse. See it safely by picking up officially licensed eclipse glasses at Doubleby's. Only $5 for one pair or $20 for five. Every one of Double B's 34 locations across Arkansas will carry these glasses. Double B's is your one-stop eclipse shop because Double B's is where you gas it, grab it, watch the eclipse, and go. That's Double B's.
It's Justin Akers for my good friends at Serta Pro Painters. And right here in Central Arkansas, you can get exactly what you need from a painting standpoint, and you can get it from the folks you trust and believe in. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated. And it comes with free estimates. You get great communication along the way and professional painting. There are certain things you should attempt on your own. In my opinion, painting is not one of them. Turn it over to the right folks at the right price. It's Serta Pro Painters. Online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
Hey there, Arkansas. It's Rowdy Hog Pickleball calling. Are you ready to join in the fun? Discover why pickleball is the fastest growing sport in America. It's an absolute blast for the whole family. Rowdy Hog Pickleball has equipment for all budgets. And here's the best part. Indoor courts are coming soon. And membership is free. Don't miss out on the action. Conveniently located in the outlets of Little Rock. And visit RowdyHogPickleball.com for your free membership.
Getting quality employees to fill positions in your company is essential. But finding those people can be a major hassle. Unless you use ZipRecruiter. ZipRecruiter makes finding quality people a breeze. And right now you can try it for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. With ZipRecruiter, one click sends your job to hundreds of top job sites. But more than that, ZipRecruiter's advanced technology identifies the candidates with the skills you need, sends you a list of great matches to review, then actively invites them to apply for your job. And the results speak for themselves. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. That's right, the first day. Now you can focus on your business and let ZipRecruiter do the work finding the best people for you. See for yourself. Experience the ease, efficiency, and power of ZipRecruiter for free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter.com/free.
The newest Edwards Food Giant, their 9th store, will open at 9 a.m. in North Little Rock at Lakewood Village on Wednesday, April 3rd. Of course, this Edwards Food Giant store will have its staples that you already love, like their certified Angus beef, hot plate deli lunches, and great customer service. But they'll also have some new and great things, like in-house dry-aged beef, a burrito and baked potato bar, and a Mediterranean bar. Plus, Edwards will also be giving away a new PK360 grill and smoker. Morning Mayhem will be broadcasting live that morning at the grand opening on April 3rd. And hopefully we'll see you there too.
What's Trending in Sports is brought to you by Arkansas' own West Rock Coffee. Join West Rock Coffee, the Razorbacks, and their 1.5 million farmers around the globe. It's fall, so now it's time for your team to stock up on coffee, tea, and water delivered directly to your business. Contact them at westrockcoffee.com or 833-886-JAVA today.
Take a look at what's trending. Wes Moore, Joe Franklin, Joe Klein. LeBron was a hot topic last night driving in, Joe. I mean, it was all over the national sports talk.
Yeah, LeBron, he continues to amaze. He got a career-high 9 threes in the game last night, along with scoring 40 against the Nets.
Show. James dancing on Claxton. 5 to shoot. Looking for 40. He's got 40.
Everywhere with a tremendous amount of efficiency. He's not 40 years old yet, but this gave him 40 here.
And that's what's amazing, too. He's 39 years old and still playing at that level.
When's he turn 40?
December. So it'll be next NBA season.
Yeah, no, he's amazing. I mean, he's amazing.
Yeah, at some point his longevity starts to come into play.
Yeah, it should already be there.
Absolutely. No, yeah. Well, and what he's doing at 40 or 39 and a half. No, he's not a volume shooter. He didn't take, 38 shots last night and get 40 points. I mean, even Kobe's last days, he would get some numbers, but he was putting them up.
Oh, yeah.
And LeBron is very, very efficient.
Also, Lakers news. A ring that Kobe Bryant gifted to his dad, Joe Jellybean Bryant, it was sold at auction for $927,000. It's the most ever paid for an NBA championship ring.
How much?
$927,000.
Hey, Joe, I got one. I'm just putting it out there right now. Anybody out there, I'll get $950.
There you go.
What was it, $927,000?
$927,000.
$900,000. Hey, you, anybody out there can have it for $900. Hey, give me another $250. I'll throw a gold medal in on that bad boy too.
No, that's right.
I would think the gold medal's worth more than the ring.
Yeah, I don't know. I just hope my wife wouldn't listen. You're not selling. I was like, first of all, Dana, nobody's going to offer me that. So we'll, let's relax there. But yeah, somebody's going to text in and say, I'll give you $900 for it.
Former NFL player Vontae Davis has passed away at the age of 35. He played 10 years in the NFL for the Dolphins, Colts, and Bills, and there's no known cause of death. He was found in his Florida home.
Hmm. The UFL got kicked off this weekend.
Yeah, they have some exciting games because you see some of the differences. Now, we talked about the NFL kickoff. The NFL kickoff is actually going to be different from what we see in the UFL because the UFL is a combination of USFL and XFL.
Mm-hmm.
So they didn't take on what the XFL is doing like NFL. It's a combo. So theirs is a little bit different. So if you watch UFL for their kickoff to see what NFL is going to look like, is actually different.
Similar but different.
Yeah.
Some similarities.
But the Michigan Panthers, they have a kicker named Jake Bates. He hit a game-winning field goal. It was a 64-yarder, and they went on to beat the St. Louis Battlehawks 18-16.
Good snap. Good hold. Line drive kick, and it is good!
Jake Bates actually played college at Arkansas. He never kicked a field goal in college. He was only a kickoff specialist. He was on with Pat McAfee talking about the game winner and some of the things he's done over the years.
How far have you been?
In practice at Arkansas, I had like 65, I guess, live. But
how about, I mean, just hold her, just hold her, just hold her, just hold her, just hold her.
Just hold her?
Yeah.
I had 67 on my pro day. But I mean, I guess it hit the ceiling, but I mean, it was going to be good. But I mean, other than that, like, I haven't really...
We got to get you to a field with a nice, you know, like 7 to 10 mile an hour behind you.
A little breeze.
A little one behind you. Maybe at altitude because your leg strength is special, brother. Keep going. We appreciate it.
I appreciate it.
Keep going, man. Hell yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, kicker from Michigan Panthers hit back-to-back 64-yarders, one after being iced, the other bringing home the first win of the Michigan Panthers season. Ladies and gentlemen, Jake Bates.
So he actually kicked the first one. They called timeout as he's going through the motion. He had to do it again.
Mm.
Made it both times.
He actually was a soccer player at UCA. Also.
Got that background.
Yeah. Pretty cool. Pretty good. You know, and he talked about on the Pat McAfee show how the kickers, he was behind some pretty good kickers. There was no ill will that he didn't get to kick at Arkansas. He's like, I was behind some really good kickers and didn't get the opportunity, so that's why he left.
Another kicker that plays for San Antonio Brahmas, Donald De La Haye. He was at UCF at one time, and he was before NIL. And they gave him a choice, basically, because he was making money off YouTube videos. You can continue that, but you have to quit college football because – they didn't allow it at the time, so he decided to go that direction. He's been a social media star forever,
yeah.
And now he's actually kicking in the UFL. So he said now that he's a professional, he has to take that serious and still do some of the same things he's doing on the side with the social media, but he's in UFL trying to make a way.
Nice. Good for him. It's a great way to prove your way and get into the NFL. They're always looking for kickers.
He's known as Destroying Online.
Destroying.
So, yeah. You can find them like that.
So Corky's in West Little Rock.
Yep.
It's a new month, but we're still doing the buffet?
Yep, it's like Vegas, man. It got, what do they say? When the show gets to keep going, what do they say?
The show goes on.
Yeah, but no, they got a, extended engagement.
Oh. buffet
The buffet got an extended engagement at Corky's West Little Rock, known as the Caesars of Barbecue.
Well, they signed a new 30-day contract.
You know, they get to live in the restaurant and get all the amenities that the restaurant has to offer.
Joe, thanks.
See you guys.
Enjoy the games this weekend.
I will, definitely. Yeah. Most definitely. Going to be some good ones.
And no doubt about it. Enjoy the games tonight. Yep. Got two really good women's games on ESPN. We'll talk about those tomorrow. Get you set for Arkansas State. Stick around. Drive Time Sports is next.
Is your Oaklawn Thoroughbred racing action so close you can feel it? Or is it the view from your trackside luxury suite? However you like it, racing season is off and running at Oaklawn, with live races every weekend through May 4th. It's fun by the furlong all season long. Make your reservations today at oaklawn.com. What's your Oaklawn? Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700.
Hey folks, I am Joseph Pena of the Arkansas Razorback basketball team.